back for round two. Wasn't expecting it to be this soon, but one should never really expect anything until it actually happens. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News, the unreliable ones. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the newsroom and welcome to the Galtopia News Network, your unreliable source for DSP News. This is the Snort Report, brought to you by Snortbucks Coffee Company, the best beverage company. Tim Snortons, stay salty, and hard snorts, gin and tonic, that toxic flavor that never wavers. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, how you guys doing? Hope you guys are doing well. Yet again, I'm going to try very hard to get us all updated, all caught up, I should say, before the hearing, which is like May 5th, I think? Or no, it's like March 5th, sorry. So I'm going to try very hard to try to get us through to get all the Snort reports at least up to date before that happens. That situation with Wings is kind of like flaring up, and that's kind of interesting, especially his logic behind why he's getting ready to marry this girl. So I'm looking forward to it. I'll go over that in the Wings report. Think about calling it the Wings retort. I don't know. You know me. I just throw names out there or different stuff out there. So we'll see how that works out. And that's basically it. Like I said, I still have the Call of Duty videos in the works. I have picked at least the first couple of wrestling videos I'm going to go over, so look forward to that. I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it on the chopping block. There might be a hiatus coming up. I'm not sure if it'll be before or after the quarterly, basically company meeting, because I need to get back onto the second channel for a little while. So we'll see. I'm not sure if that'll be, it'll more likely be after the hearing and whatnot. So there you go. But you guys have people like Agent Proper, James the Lesser. You have what other good channels you got there? You got Robin Zeffa. You got a bunch of great channels out there to kind of get opinions on until I make my triumphant return, so to speak. So that's the thing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's not go ahead and hold off any longer, shall we? So let's go ahead and set the mood a little bit. Set the mood. Let's see. Let's turn that down just slightly. Kind of missed having the kind of jazz number back up there. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here. We are here for round two of this epic excursion, if you will, that is absolutely unnecessary, and I feel like Phil's just digging himself into a bigger hole. Which, if you guys remember on the last broadcast, I already told him that the hole's already out back. I don't have these paws for no reason. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with Mighty D, DSP, Toxic Wing Rant. Which is weird. Like, why are you ranting on Wings, Phil? Like Wings didn't do shit to you. He defends you. I don't know why he defends you, but he defends you. Anyway, Toxic Wings Rant and denies knowing Gamer J. Lee, despite the fact there's videos out there, like old Cax the Kings, where he brings Gamer J. Lee's name up. Okay, whatever. Anyway, this is brought to us by Mighty D. This is from February 18th of 2020, our current year of gout, as you guys know. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to hold off any longer. Let's just go ahead and get into this, you know what I'm saying? I'm looking to get some bacon. I'm looking to go ahead and make some candy bacon BLTs. It's been a while since I've actually kind of made something. And since we don't have any tasty in this broadcast, it's kind of a thing. Hope you guys, by the way, like the newest commercial that was made by Chio18. She put a lot of time and effort into it, so I hope you guys really like it. And that's pretty much it. You know what I'm saying? Let's go ahead and get into this bacony goodness, shall we? Maybe I should make something called deviled bacon. I was actually considering this. Let me spurg for a second. So I was thinking, like, I'm thinking sriracha or honey sriracha if I can find it. I've only had that like once or twice. It's just delicious if you can find it. But anyway, I'm thinking like honey sriracha or just honey and sriracha, right? I'll cook the bacon to a nice crispy, you know, just before the point of crispy. And then I'll add the honey sriracha to it, and I'll like give it like a quick broil and bring it right back out, because as you know, sugar will, especially sugar when in contact with bacon fat, will burn if you don't watch it. So literally only needs like a couple of minutes. So, and then that on like, you know, on like a nice like toasted sour bread, if you will, you know what I'm saying, or toasted white bread if you like, whatever, you know what I'm saying, quick hit of Hellman's, fresh cut lettuce, tomato, and then just stacked up with like, you know, six strips of bacon. Some good eating. Anyway, we'll see how that all plays out. But ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and get into it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Snort Report, and this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network and Productions. You guys all know the slogan. I don't smell no bacon cooking. So we're going to go ahead and get right on that. Because why wouldn't he? And then we'll be serving up hard snorts to follow that. I feel like a lot of you guys need some food in your stomach before you guys start drinking. You guys all know the slogan. It's time to watch me work.
Here's Phil to tell you more.
All right, who we give us somebody else, y'all. All right, Dark Side Phil. Look like he's doing all right.
Got it.
There he is.
Yeah, man. Playing Classic Doom.
I guess in honor of Doom Eternal. Okay.
Coming out soon.
Oh, my God,
next month.
Man.
All right, let's see here. Oh, the chat is gone.
No.
Oh, no.
All right.
Oh, no.
This is... Oh, my God. I figured out the room, and I have 32 health left. Okay.
Right, here we go.
Here we go,
Yeah, we're getting ready to raid right now.
Not here. He must be downstairs sleeping. He didn't follow me.
Okay, so this must be the raid that Phil ignored, which is funny, too, because, well, ladies and gentlemen, we're here with Mighty D, DSP, Toxic Wings Rant, and denies... Knowing Gamer J. Lee. This is from February 18th, 2020, our current year of gout. Ladies and gentlemen, this right here is the stream rant, or the stream raid, that Phil received the other night. Or, well, it was probably a few nights ago at the time that I'm recording this. But, and Phil sat there and completely ignored it. And this goes back to something that I've said before, where I think Phil likes these small, you know, his little 300, 400, count streams, because he does know the stream count. He knows exactly how many people are on there. But I think he likes these little streams, right? With the smallest group of people possible, because it's easy for him to moderate these people. It's easy for him to keep track of all the names. It's easy to keep track of all of their activities. It's like a babysitter in a lot of ways, I think. But then again, he relegates all of them to children anyway, because most of them aren't children, so it is what it is. And so when he gets a large influx of people, he gets scared, he gets paranoid. We've seen all this before. But, Phil, this is how you grow. But that's the Phil side of it. That's the pignosis side of it. That's the paranoia part of it. Let's talk about other streamers and how they perceive Darkside Phil. A lot of them just kind of perceive him as everybody else does, as a joke. But you have those group of people who used to watch him back in the day. I'm not saying they're fanboys. I'm not saying that they're cucks. I'm not saying, or piggy cucks. I'm not saying that they're pay pigs. You're just people that, oh, I remember Darkside Phil from back in the day, whatever, whatever. These people have all gone on, grown up, you know what I'm saying, actually did shit with their lives. And they stream occasionally, and they're like, oh, well, Darkside Phil's there. Well, we have a good number of people here. Let's go ahead and raid Darkside Phil. Let's see how Darkside Phil's doing. The amount of chances that Phil gets is ridiculous. It's redunculous. And it's amazing how someone has all of this good faith, right? All of this quote-unquote good karma with certain people who haven't been keeping up with his spurgery and his bullshit over the last couple years, who try to come in and help him. And to kind of see how they react to how Phil reacts to their reciprocation. Phil is one of those people that you can't help. You know what I mean? Like, realistically, you can't help him. He, in his own mind, is his own hero, and he knows what the hell he needs to do and whatnot, and it's people like Tevin that are holding him back. And if it wasn't for the fact that Tevin was around, big ups to Almighty Tevin, obviously, if Tevin wasn't around, then it wouldn't be so goddamn bad. Well, when the fuck is Phil gonna grow up and stop blaming another individual for his problems? Especially when Tevin isn't even on his ass as much as most people. So why the hell do you have to keep bringing Tevin up in this situation for every little, you know, for every little thing that happens to you? Why can't you just accept that maybe you're just a fucking failure because you won't listen to anything that anybody's ever told you? And anything that you did listen to, you turned it around and made it sound like you had an epiphany and it was your idea. At the end of the day, your downfall is squarely in your own hooves. Period. No one can grasp it. Well, everybody can grasp it, but you're the only one who can't grasp it because you have hooves. You don't have thumbs. You're about to be pig feet. It is what it is. Good eating. And so, but the fact that you still have people out here who are like, well, you know, haven't seen Darkseid Phil in a while. Let's go ahead and, you know, raid him real quick and, you know, let's see if we can, you know, try to boost him up a little bit. I respect it, but sadly, it's a waste. There are streamers out there who've been on Twitch, because I've seen a couple of them, who've been on Twitch for a year, maybe longer, and whatnot. And they're only bringing in, you know, 20, 30, 40 viewers a night. And they don't complain about it. They don't bitch about it. They keep grinding. You know what I'm saying? They keep trying to update the content. They keep trying to do new stuff. I think they try to change too fast. You make it gradual. And I know because I've tried doing that too. you can't do too much too fast. Be gradual about it and see how the audience kind of receives it before you start making total changes and whatnot. But that's just my own personal opinion. They, I think, would be not only much more appreciative of it, but they would be able to capitalize a little bit more off of it. But then let's also be honest, ladies and gentlemen, even though I don't stream, I watch a lot of streamers, but I don't stream. That just because a bigger streamer shouts you out or raids you or whatever the case may be doesn't mean those people will stick around. That's another thing, you know? So you got to take that into account too. Some will, you know? Maybe 10, if you're lucky, 15% of them will. But not everybody. So you kind of have to grasp the moment while you can. Since we are talking about Wings, even though this isn't the Wings Report, Wings is bringing in, what, 700-800, you know, people per stream? Even though the majority of it's hate watching, he still has them. He has them there. When was the last time Phil pulled that shit that wasn't drama? That wasn't bullshit? Like, that retrospective stream that's coming up is going to be garbage. That's going to be garbage. God bless whoever, you know what I'm saying, whoever decides to go ahead and try to restream that shit. Because that's going to be horrible. You know what I mean? That's going to be horrible. He's going to sit there and basically do reaction style videos, which is funny because that's supposed to be garbage content, according to Darkseid Phil. To his own garbage. The same garbage that we saw in the last retrospective stream and in the one before it, to be honest. That even he realizes that there's nothing interesting going on in his content. But yet he feels like it still needs to be defended because it has value. Value to who? You're saying that, when I mean him, I'm saying DSP, says that YouTube money is almost non-existent. Everything's all about the streaming, guys. It's about the contributions. It's about the crowdfunding. Then why the hell are you still clenching onto YouTube? Onto your little shekels over there. Why is it that you had to hold YouTube basically over the fire twice, and I think in 2018, that if they don't step up, everything's going to go away? Well, even when they did try to step up, keyword is try, you're still going to lose everything probably. At the end of the day, they were empty threats that meant nothing. Because Phil wasn't going to give up what little YouTube money there is. Because Phil has this delusion that all of a sudden, one day out of the blue, he's going to wake up and YouTube's going to turn around. And he's going to be back on top, as pathetic as that is. He really believes that. He honestly believes that. We'll talk about that further when the time comes on that. But let's go ahead and see how this all works out, right? DSP news.
Upstairs when I was getting set up for work and everything, he didn't follow me.
Give us just a little more time.
What the fuck is this?
Our love will surely grow.
That's it. Okay. Meeting. Nirvana. That was stage 21.
All right.
Good lord.
Let me see. He's about to show up now.
The catacombs. This sounds great.
Holy moly, man.
All right, we're gonna just
we'll see.
Again.
Can you imagine?
I'm
just
gonna do
like,
some of
the
stage, but I'm not gonna. Be,
oh,
not
here we are.
This tonight.
Really? Here we are. Game some people.
I've only got about another 15 minutes
right
left
now
on stream.
Yeah.
Look at that. He's already like. He's already trying not to look at it, and then he's like, oh, well, I only got another 15 minutes left on stream. Why? You're getting a buzz from a bunch of people, and automatically the paranoia kicks in. He doesn't even have an assessment of what the situation is yet. Just feel it out and see what happens. I thought Twitch is supposed to be your platform. I thought Twitch is supposed to be your thing. And look at how scared he is. This is coming from an asshole, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, who had other people deplatformed. But now all of a sudden he's getting raided. He's getting a little bit of shine, if you will. And already running scared. already, haven't even put the bacon in the goddamn pan yet, and he's already ready to go. What a coward. Jesus Christ. Swear to God, like, the whole world is coming out to get him. So sad. But yet, we're the bad guys, ladies and gentlemen. All of you. I'm definitely an offender, apparently, of piggy abuse, apparently. But all of you guys are watching it, so you guys are kind of just feeding into me offending on this. You guys are feeding my bacon addiction, and now I have to go off and steal more bacon to feed that addiction. You guys should all feel terrible. I'm just kidding. But in Phil's mind, that's how he looks at it. Which is wild. I don't hold any of you guys at piggy point to watch videos. You don't have to. But Phil makes it sound like, you know, we all, like, all the tractors are basically forcing people to watch their content and give them money. It would be absolutely humorous if it wasn't actually true. Like, if there wasn't an idiot out there who really thought like this, it would actually be funny. You know? It's something that you could tell a bunch of people and have a couple of drinks over. And you guys would think that shit's hilarious. The sad part is it's all too real. I mean, in his head, but it's all too real.
Notice us!
On the stream. So I'll play for about another 10 minutes. Thank you guys, everyone.
15 minutes turned into 10 minutes. Look at him. I haven't even put him in the pan yet. I haven't even heated the pan yet. I haven't even cut the bread. And he already running scared. Look at him. Wee, all the way back to Catherine.
Tonight?
He's leaving.
And let's continue.
Oh, okay, good. Did it go through? Yeah, it went through. Oh, maybe he doesn't have a raid notification.
Yeah, he don't see us. He doesn't see us.
He might not even.
Totally fair.
Get this fool's attention!
Yeah!
Show him the toasty goodness, guys. Come on.
Totally fair. Mm-hmm.
He doesn't see nothing.
He doesn't see
nothing.
His
notification's not on. So.
All right. Well,
I think he's watching something.
He's watching the game.
Yeah, watching the game. He pay attention to his chat. Give him 400 plus people. You're welcome.
14% health. Not good.
Look at him purposely. First off, you guys are used to seeing Phil every 10, 15 seconds turning over to look at that chat, is what he does. The way his body's positioned, you can tell. Like it's almost like he's in defense mode, if you will. I'm trying to block, dude. He's trying to block his own chat. He doesn't want to look at it. Which is weird because any other day, he'd be knee-deep in that shit. He'd be knee-deep in the muck, which is that Gestapo chat. But now, 15 minutes turned into 10 minutes. I didn't realize 5 minutes went by so quickly. And now, I don't even want to look at the chat. I'm not even trying to give it that type of light. I'm telling you, man, there's certain people in life you can't be nice to. You really can't. Sometimes a person needs to fail to learn. Sometimes a person. There are people out there that just kind of need to fail. You know what I mean? Like, they need to hit rock bottom if they're ever going to get better. It's just what has to happen for some people. You know what I mean? And you don't want to see it because you don't want anybody to hit rock bottom because the climb up is arduous. And no one wants to see anybody really struggle, believe it or not. No one wants to see anybody struggle. But Phil was quick to laugh at everybody who fell off the mountain, you know, who went tumbling, you know, off the sides. He didn't have a problem with that. But the moment that he starts falling or he starts slipping even, then all of a sudden he's grasping at whatever he can. And he'll take whoever down with him if he needs to, if it'll help break his fall or if it'll get him back into position. And you can't help people like that. You can't. You just got to let them fall. Just let them fall. Just my opinion, of course.
Of course. Not good that you're not looking at.
God damn it.
He looked right over there.
Instantly died.
All right, everybody. We are out of here.
See that? You know what I'm saying? And he went right back to his usual, you know, behavior. But these guys, I'm glad they kind of smartened up and saw it as early as they did. You wasted your time. And look at him. They didn't have to raid him. They could have given that opportunity to anybody else. And it got pissed away on Dark Side Phil. the King John of the fucking internet. Failure incarnate. The snorts of war. That's who they decided to waste that raid on. And that could have gone to someone who really would have appreciated it. Now, they didn't know. They didn't know. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't hold no ill will against them. How could I? They chose to do it. It is what it is. I'm just here to laugh at it. But it wasn't worth it. Phil's not worthy of generosity. He's already received a lot of it. And he pissed almost all of it away. Just my opinion, of course.
All right. Thank you guys very much. It's been a lot of fun, but now we must bid you adieu.
Let's see here. PW Dubs sent me $1.30. He says, one day, I'm going to do a raid on another streamer's channel. I probably wouldn't want to, because it basically brings negative influence onto other people's channels. What? I'll give you an example. The other day, I guess there was some streamer, I don't know who the hell it was, they were talking shit about me, okay? So someone actually came into the chat saying, Phil, this other streamer's talking shit about you. And I'm like, I don't care. Who gives a shit? People do it every day, right? Then, apparently, because that happened, because
wait,
the streamer...
people talk shit about me all the time, or every day. I don't give a shit. I don't care. But yet, hasn't he had some detractor rants about how we're all immoral, and we're all pieces of shit, and this whole lolcow thing that we keep doing, and that it's sick, and it's disgusting, and we all need to look in the mirror and come to some type of rationalization about our behavior and how our frame of mind is and how toxic it is. But now he don't give a fuck. Now he don't give a shit.
Alright. Got some attention on my stream for talking shit about me. I guess some haters went into his room and basically tried to pretend like they were my fans, and they were like, DSP sent us and he says you're an asshole and blah blah blah. And then people came to my Twitter and were like, man, you're a real asshole for sending your followers after the streamer. Just because he criticized you on his stream doesn't mean that you should harass him on a stream. I was like, what? Like, go watch my stream archive. At that point, I hadn't even taken it down yet. I was like, go watch my stream archive. I didn't ask anyone.
I don't believe that. Because Phil's quick to make that archive disappear. Like, real quick. Like, he's faster than Wings. And Wings is all about that life. Like, all about that life. So, I don't believe that at all. I've watched Tevin streams where if it wasn't for the fact that Tevin already had it open in a tab, it was literally just minutes after, you know, Phil left and after the ads and everything roll, shit was gone. Like that. Which is funny because I thought Phil said that Tevin's the coward who's always hiding his streams and hiding his nefarious acts and all that, but why does Phil have to delete all of his stuff so quickly? Especially when it's going to take him about a half hour to get all that uploaded onto YouTube anyway. That seems rather peculiar. Oh well. DSP News.
Do anything. I don't even know who that person is. So you're barking up the wrong fucking tree here, you know? But that's what I mean. Like, if even people who just say negative stuff about me get attacked, can you imagine coming into someone's stream to raid and do something positive, how it would be turned against the whole intention?
But I thought negative people were assholes. And how is it that, yet again, we live in a world where Dark Side Phil looks at criticism as a bad thing, even though he has told us before. If you guys, let's travel back for a minute. Okay, let's take a walk. You know what I'm saying? Help the alcohol flow and everything. You guys remember back during the shilling saga where Phil said that everybody was shills and they were assholes and they weren't true gamers and this, that, and the third? But more importantly, when he was saying that, the people who participate in sponsored streams and stuff like that, they can't give their or the bounty board. That's a good example as well. He said, they can't actually give their honest opinion about a game. You know what I mean? And I don't respect that practice, because if you can't get an honest opinion about the game, then how are you conveying your actual thoughts honestly? You know what I mean? And when he said that, the first thing that came to my head was, why does honesty have to equate to being negative? And if that is the case, then why can't you deal with that, Phil? Why is it that DSP, Dark Side Phil Burnell, Dark Geppetto, King of Hate, can't actually accept an honest opinion about himself if, in his own piggy mind, that negativity is the equivalent of honesty? Why can't you accept that? I thought you said, Phil, that we were all liars riding your coattails for money. We give a negative connotation about you. We give off negative vibes about who you are. We take shit about you out of context. But in your own head, you say that if people can't give an honest opinion about something, then that makes them liars. But we all know that your honest opinion is to criticize the game, because you said something of that variance. Well, that seems a bit counterintuitive, and a bit contradicting, and a bit asshole-ish. That seems strange, doesn't it, ladies and gentlemen? But now, all of a sudden, oh, well, I can't even join the bounty board. You know, I've been kicked off of that, so I can't even use it now. So he doesn't even bring that notion up anymore. Except for when he was playing, what game was it that he acted like a complete and total bitch? He showed his ass, and it was I literally felt ashamed of him. Well, I feel ashamed about him a lot, but you know, I definitely felt ashamed of him then. Was that Assassin's Creed Odyssey? Maybe? I think that was the last Assassin's Creed game. And you remember how we had the bounty board for that? And he actually used it. Now, the funny thing was, if you guys remember, you guys are going to have to dig back into your pig lore. The week before, he was talking all of his hot... I mean, he liked the game, but he didn't like the game. He had his complaints. He had all this hot shit he had to say about it the last two sessions. Then we got into the bounty board situation in that stream, that sponsored stream, if you will. And boy, it was all Hallmark cards and bubbles at that point. He didn't have a negative thing to say about it for the 2 hours or however long it was he was playing that game. He completely turned around and turned into a complete and total shill, apparently. A complete and total asshole who went back on his own word. But yet again, ladies and gentlemen, riddle me this. How is it that an individual who has stylized himself and marketed himself, and I use that term loosely, as the king of hate, the realest guy on YouTube, the honest guy, and someone whose MO is to shit on things and people and then use the shield of, oh, well, that's my honest opinion. How does he get mad at other people who have criticisms of him if they're just being honest? If one looks at the world in his little glass box, right, as being honest, how does that work? I don't know. Maybe we'll figure it out as we move along. TSP news.
And just cause a bunch of negative nonsense, because that's happened before with other streamers that I've had association with, is that these shitheads follow me around. They cause nonsense in those people's streams, and those people get harassed and hassled. Eric to me, dollar said, what do you think of waifu culture? I think it's stupid, you know? I really do. Like, I think that it's like...
Here's a perfect example. What do you think of waifu culture? It's not for me. It's not for me. But to each their own. What does Phil say? Oh, it's stupid. Hey, Phil, what do you think about homosexuality? Oh, well, you know, whatever. You know, to each their own. You know, that's not my cup of tea. We've all heard this before. So we have an individual who picks and chooses what is the least offensive thing to say if it could really get him fucked up. So, you know, like how Discord is kind of run by furries, or at least allegedly? If you think about it, Twitch is run by a bunch of people who basically favor waifus over anything else. Well, I guess if Phil had any real clout, or if Phil had said something maybe about Alinity or Amaran, maybe Pokimane, if one was to consider her a waifu of anything, maybe there'd be a problem there. You would think Mr. Honest Individual would be a bit more consistent across the board, especially with something small like this. But then again, this is the same idiot, ladies and gentlemen, who, excuse me, who refused to play Code Vein because of digital titties. That's essentially what that was. He's treating the anime waifu type games like it's an affront to Catherine. But isn't that a bit of a contradiction? Because there's a new fighting game coming out that looks really good, by the way. And Phil's gonna excuse me. And Phil's gonna play that. And there's a whole lot of just jiggly stuff going on with that. Sorry, Catherine can't compare. But we're gonna play that though. Seems, I don't know. Seems weird. Seems very strange.
It's just so dumb. For me, I want a meaningful
Oh, now we're gonna walk it back. What a coward.
Oh, shit. For me, I look for meaningful relationships with real humans. I'm not looking for a virtual fucking relationship.
You look for meaningful relationships with real people. Oh, excuse me just a second. Bacon's almost ready. So, he looks for meaningful relationships with real people. This is coming from the same idiot, ladies and gentlemen, who only leaves his house once a day, or once a week. Once a day. He should leave his house once a day, but once a week. And when he does, he only leaves with Catherine. And though he is quote-unquote online, and he quote-unquote interacts with people all day, he doesn't actually know them. He doesn't actually give a fuck about them. He doesn't really care about interacting with them outside of, oh, I'm going to sit here and play games terribly. You guys give me money, and you guys praise me for me being the underdog, like he knows what the fuck that means, and for my perseverance, as if he knew what the fuck that was. That's essentially it. He gets paid to exist. But he looks at that as meaningful interaction with other human beings. This is the same person when people try to collab with him on Twitch. He's like, no, I don't really want to do that. I'm not interested in doing that. You know what I mean? He's the same person that's like, hey, Phil, you know, I was watching this guy here, and this guy actually had some pretty decent advice with you. Yeah, I don't care about that. I know what I'm doing. That right there is someone who's looking for meaningful relationships with real people when he's only isolated to his house with his wife and his stepson, Jasper. He's more desensitized to IRL than probably anybody. Even Wings leaves his house. And I don't mean just for chili. And Yoohoo. He drinks a lot of Yoohoo, surprisingly enough. Not that I have anything against Yoohoo, but I'm saying he drinks a lot of Yoohoo. Speaking of which, I've been messing with this white chocolate milk. It's white chocolate milk, basically. That shit's godlike good. So good. So good. Anyway, sorry. My apologies on that. But that's supposed to be meaningful interaction. How anybody followed him, I'll never know. I'll never know. Absolute clown world shit.
Shit. I'm not looking for a virtual relationship.
You're already in a virtual relationship. You're in a virtual relationship with your audience. He didn't even talk to his girlfriend. Let's run that back. I'm sorry. He didn't even talk to his soulmate, who ended up being the second fiancé, who finally became Mrs. Snort. He didn't even talk to her on the phone until she finally got there to Seattle, Washington. Or to Washington, I should say. He didn't speak to her on the phone once. He sat there, slipped into that chick's DMs, gave her some pitter-patty petty story about him being a fucking alcoholic and how he needed her help, and then went ahead and they were texting each other behind Subaru Man's back until he could finally get her up and out of the house and over there. He didn't really know her. They had no real meaningful interaction before the first time she flew out there. And if you think about that, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and look at the picture, look at this in a much bigger picture, at a larger scope. She sat there and agreed to go out and meet someone that she had never really seen before and stay in his house for X amount of days and didn't really know who the person was. She didn't know who Phil was and Phil didn't know who she was. Ain't that some wild shit? I mean, don't get me wrong, you know, we've all gone on a blind date or two, you know what I'm saying? We've all had first date hookups, you know, we get that. But Jesus Christ, you're like states away from your home. You don't necessarily have an option. Like, you're kind of just stuck there. You know what I'm saying? For good or bad. Yikes. Yikes. When you think about it, that whole situation, ladies and gentlemen, I told y'all I thought it was fake. I told y'all I thought it was all smoke and mirrors. Because the relationship started off in a very awkward sort of way. It's very strange. And now that I say that, you can't tell me that this idiot didn't know that this bankruptcy thing was on the horizon. At the time that that Kat agreed to marry him, he knew, he had to have known that this foreclosure or this bankruptcy thing was on the horizon. He had to have known. He had to have known. I don't know.
With a virtual girl in a fucking anime or something. It's so dumb. I'm sorry. Sorry that I'm a realist. You know? Timony's $2 million, so you're taking the waifu thing way too serious. It's basically a wee version of a celebrity crush. That's the thing. Crushes, in essence, crushes are incredibly immature. They're for people who are immature. They are. When I was young and I was a teenager, I had crushes. I haven't had a crush on anyone, you know, since like, you know, I was in my early 20s probably. You know, I would say probably, yeah, that was probably the last fucking time. It's something that you grow out
of. Is that when you were on that cocktail of pills and, you know, you were kind of really out of your mind and you were really obsessed with this girl and, you know, you kind of got worried that you were going to, you know, you thought you were going to end up doing something, you know, you might regret? You mean like that? Dude, to say crushes are immature is, it's kind of just silly. It's kind of just part of growing up. And some people grow out of it, some people don't. You know what I'm saying? I mean, then again, if memory serves me right, the last one, when we were on that cocktail of medication, that wasn't even a crush. He was obsessed with that shit. He even said it, you know, he was like obsessed with this girl and this, that, and a third. That's on that sicko shit that Phil likes to talk. Womp womp. That's on that shit. Sounds like someone that's mentally unstable and who couldn't take no for an answer or couldn't take the hint or couldn't read the room. That's what that sounds like. A crush is a crush. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Sometimes it passes over or it depends on whether you act upon it or not. No biggie. It is what it is. Everybody's gone through it. Usually when you're young, but some people carry that over. It is what it is. You'd be surprised in whatever workspace that you're at, right? No matter what the level or whatever school you're going to or whatever the case may be, or whatever bus that you take home, or whatever it's, or wherever you walk your dog, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, or wherever. You don't know who's watching you. You know? You don't know whose attention that you're drawing at any given time. You never know. Maybe they'll tell you, maybe they won't. As long as it doesn't go too far, you're all right. But to say that, but just to outright dismiss it because you think you're above it is kind of shitty. Especially coming from the same idiot who's a realist but sat on his ass and let a condo go into foreclosure that didn't have to, and then let himself go into bankruptcy because he was okay with getting money from different financial institutions and whatnot, but he didn't want to pay it back. It's kind of like that game or those few games that people have sent to Phil to play, and Phil's never played the games, and Phil never sent them back. It's kind of like that. It's kind of like some ungrateful bullshit like that. But whatever. DSP News?
You mature. But people on the internet love to act like it's a commonplace thing and it's like normalized okay behavior. That even if you have like a significant other, I still have a waifu and a crush and all that. It's fucking stupidity. That's called being incredibly immature. And I don't want to deal with that shit. So enough of that nonsense. Streetcast show me to me $5 said, how's the chill stream? Did you and can have a fun Valentine's Day? No, in reality, our Valentine's Day absolutely sucked. We both had to work, and Kat was already feeling under the weather. So, in reality, it was a bad day. Mature adults...
Alright, so two things. One, we already knew in advance that he wasn't going anywhere for Valentine's Day. They spent Valentine's Day, I think, like the day before. Like, the day before Valentine's Day, they went off and did something. So, it is what it is. I think he said that, oh, we can only afford dinner, or whatever the case may be. Which is ironic, because wasn't he kind of begging for a large amount of money leading up to Valentine's Day? Semantics, I'm sure. Anyway, as it pertains to the online wifey type thing, or waifu type thing, or whatever, even if you're in a relationship, so on and so forth. Yet again, semantics. Take that for whatever you will. Everybody has like a celebrity crush or whatever the case may be, or, you know, whatever, I guess. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is on that. But ladies and gentlemen, maybe we should go ahead and look at things as a dark side Phil way. So maybe, when I'm ready to settle down and have some little GTGs of my own, I should go ahead and make up a story to some, I don't know, random chick online that I've only been stalking on Twitter. That, hey, I have an addiction and I need you. And I need your help badly. Because if not, I'm going to probably end up doing something crazy. I need your help. And maybe I should just go ahead and play upon that. And then fly her out 3 or 4 times before I finally end up snatching her from whoever her previous boyfriend or ex or present boyfriend or ex-boyfriend, whatever, that she's currently with. Maybe that's the dark side Phil way of going about it. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been all doing it wrong. If you want somebody, right, go ahead and develop an addiction and then use that to get pity points with them to make them feel sorry for you and come out. And then when you get that pity sex, go ahead and look at the mirror when you're done, after, you know, the 5 minutes or ever, however Phil lasts. We all know the stroke game ain't on point. And you can go ahead and put your hoof in the air and be like, I take the hate. And I go ahead and I use it to make myself a powerful person. Do that, ladies and gentlemen. That sounds like the way to go. DSP News?
Graduated wings on his engagement? No, I don't know. Listen, this may shock some of you. I don't know Wings of Redemption. I don't talk to Wings of Redemption. It doesn't make a lot of money. Real talk, I know it doesn't.
Real talk.
Real talk.
Real talk.
Right? I have no interaction with Wings of Redemption besides you guys constantly bringing him up on my fucking streams because you're obsessed with this fucking guy and you can't leave him alone.
Wow, now, this is pretty pathetic coming from an individual who says people are obsessed with him and they won't leave him alone. All you have to do, ass clown, is go ahead and say, hey, congratulations to Wings. That's it. Isn't this the same asshole who went ahead and put his information on Instagram and Twitter, hoping that some people were going to come out and congratulate him, and then got mad when, oh, none of the other big YouTubers or streamers wished him congratulations? Because none of them knew, or they didn't care. But then he got a little salty right around the time, right? Big ups to Loco Slam on this. He got real salty around the time PewDiePie got married and whatnot. And, you know, everybody came out for that. And everybody was retweeting that and this, that, and the third. And he was pretty salty about that one. Oh, he wasn't happy that the biggest guy on YouTube, biggest gamer on YouTube, Muppet or not, was having his grown-up wedding and actually had friends who showed up and had a real nice wedding too, like that, like a really, really nice wedding. And had all those friends around and this, that, and third. And Phil didn't have none of that. And had all these people retweeting and wishing them best of luck and best wishes and so on and so forth. Phil didn't like that. Phil didn't like that. But what's Phil want to do? He want to be an ass clown to someone who, in a lot of ways, I won't completely blow the lid off this because, you know, we'll save that for the wings report. I got some delicious wing cooked up for y'all. He has someone who's essentially following in his footsteps when it comes to this lolcow wedding type shit. Because Wings is kind of marrying this girl, right, for a reason. And I'm not necessarily saying that it's love. It's more of necessity, a utility more than anything. Just my opinion, of course. But then again, didn't Phil refer to Catherine as the second income before she finally popped up? It seems like the lolcow brothers have more in common than they're willing to give each other, you know, respect for. Maybe even a little bit more than they're willing to acknowledge. But, you know, I'm just an asshole on the internet, ladies and gentlemen. What do I know? DSP News.
That's the only thing I know about Wings. Why would I congratulate someone on getting engaged who I don't talk to and know nothing about?
Because that's just being a decent person, whether you know them or not. That's a thing. Here, let me give you an example, Phil. Let me give you an example. So, LSP, Lightside Bill. You guys all know Lightside Bill and Rocky, right? You know, Rocky, obviously, is the Rocky show, and LSP is the co-host, but you know how that is, right? Big ups to Rocky and LSP. But LSP is engaged, and he's getting married. I don't know LSP. I may have talked to LSP less than a handful of times, but I don't have any issues with LSP, first off. And two, I'm happy for him, and I wish him the best. And when he finally does get married, you can bet your bottom goddamn dollar that I'm going to at least retweet, or I'm going to definitely tweet at him and say, congratulations. Because that's just what decent people do. You don't know you don't know Jordy. You don't know Wings, but you are acquainted with Wings. You know of him. You have a way of reaching out to him. It's just being a decent individual. It's just being a decent person. But see, in the world of Galtopia, ladies and gentlemen, one cannot look outside of the bubble. If everybody else around Phil doesn't exist, and if they do, they're all obsessed demons who, you know, are literally pulling at the, you know, the snorting savior, or snorting savory at this point, because, you know, sandwiches are about to be, you know, distributed and whatnot, because it's starting to time. I'm ready for my first drink. And so that's how it all works. You know, everybody who's true and honest fans, you guys are the saints. And for everybody else, it's literally the apocalypse. And we're just kind of clawing away at everybody else. Which is kind of ridiculous, to say the very least. If the ass clown doesn't want to deal with what he's dealing with, tell him to get the fuck off the internet and get a job. Oh, because his dumb ass can't do anything else. Because he had boxed himself into a position that he'll never be able to get out of. Because he has no skills, he has no ability, he has no drive, he has no resolve. And he can't do nothing else. He can't do nothing else. Okay. And now you have someone who you've ridiculed on your own streams, which is ironic because you've gone further on Wings than Wings ever went on you. Even when that whole thing a couple years ago, when you lied to those guys, you lied to Wings, Jive Turkey, what's that guy's name? That dude, Eddie, and White Boy 7th Street. You lied to them and said that you were sick that week when they asked you to come onto their podcast. You lied to them and said you were sick and you weren't. You were making videos that day. Because you have this nice little habit, Phil, of saying, hey guys, today is such and such day, whatever, whatever, we're getting ready to play this. Which is ironic because that's the day you were supposed to be on that podcast. So you lied to them. And they basically were like, oh, well, he said, he gave me a roundabout reason on why he didn't want to come on, you know, is what it is. And what'd they say? They said what they were supposed to say. Fuck them. Whatever. And they kept it moving. And you want to hold it against Jordy on that, and that's why you didn't want to collab with him on Battlefield or Call of Duty. I think that was World War II. I think it was. You didn't want to collab with him because of those things. And then you were letting people meme on him and shit in your chat. And you were even laughing at the memes and even saying it yourself. But I don't know this fucking guy. I don't know nothing about him except for what you guys are obsessed. You guys are so obsessed with him and it don't make no sense. Even though Jordy... You're a fucking idiot, by the way, Jordy. You sat there and defended him on... You've defended Phil on your stream. For no goddamn reason. And yet he still keeps going at you. But he don't know you, though. And you're not worthy of his blessing. Of his congratulatory snort on your engagement. However legitimate that shit is. Jordy is probably one of the few people who understands what Phil is going through. Who really understands. Not that fucking bullshit that Rich from Review Tech USA tried to do. Don't get me wrong, he's a loyal cow too. And he did a lot of the shit that DSP did and tried it. But he said for years, oh, I learned a lot of my mistakes from watching Phil. And that's why I didn't do them. But then you went ahead and did them in a different way. Huh. That don't make a whole lot of sense either. But whatever, semantics. But if nothing else, Jordy is the closest person that can understand the shit that Phil's gone through. And the shit Phil is going through. And like I said, it's arguably, and I argue that Jordy gets it worse. Phil is one of the few people, that is one of the few, those are the two loyal cows that can relate to each other. For sure. And Wings has tried to reach out to him and be like, you know, hey man, you know, I get it, you know, it is what it is, keep it pushing or whatever. And a little bit of positive reinforcement between the two of them is not going to hurt, well, they can only hurt each other, really. But DSP still believes he's above him. And in actuality, you're going to lose more than Jordy did. And Jordy's lost a lot. And I'm not saying that it wasn't his fault. Because Jesus Christ, the majority of that shit was his fault. And for someone who talks about, I'm all about having that human interaction. There is someone out there who has tried very hard to have that interaction with you. Outside of the usual people who... you know, surround you. And you've always thought that you were better than him. When in actuality, he's always been bigger than you. Look at what Wings of Redemption content, the views they get compared to like DSP stuff. You know what I'm saying? That right there gauges the type of reach Jordy has. And DSP don't see that. And that's what DSP is resentful of. Because Wings is bigger than him. He has bigger stream numbers. He has bigger... His YouTube channel's bigger. And that shit's damn near dead. Because, you know, Jordy don't pay no attention to it. But if Jordy started, you know, putting content back on there, people would watch it. And the search engine is already in his favor because of all of the detractor content out on him. Jordy knows that. Because Jordy knows how to play the search engine. That type of information DSP could use. You guys see how these two could complement each other a little bit? But see, but DSP looks at it as, oh no, Jordy has to be subservient to me. He's beneath me and he has to be that way. And Jordy's not going to do that. Not to accommodate you. Like I said, the one person out there that can understand what you're going through, you want to keep pissing on him like he's some turd. And at the end of the day, Jordy has a better chance of turning shit around than you ever could. I think you realize that too. I think that's why you're resentful against him. Oh well. DSP News.
I don't know if he's really engaged or not, if you guys are lying. I have no idea. I don't give a fuck. So, how about this?
Stop. You mean like how you lied about your own wedding? Oh, that's right. If DSP lies, and everybody else is liars too. I forgot. My bad.
Dumb fucking questions about another streamer? Shut the fuck up about it. Grow the fuck up, because if you keep doing it and pissing me off, I'm going to put my virtual foot up your virtual ass, and you're not going to be in my stream anymore. How about that?
How does that... Wow. That's what this is how a 37-year-old acts, sitting here playing kid games. Threatening to go ahead and put his virtual hoof up someone's virtual ass. Oh, that's interesting. Nice way to go ahead and skew by the TOS, I guess. Not as if they were going to act upon it anyway. Jesus Christ. And this is what people choose to defend. This is it. This is your lard and snort that you guys want. That, well, not you guys, but you know what I mean. That people choose to defend. This type of behavior, this type of action. But yet, it's funny how DSP is in the worst possible place of his life. And he might lose big. Because he's gambled heavily. And it's going to come back on his ass. It's going to come back on his ass. And he wants all the help and sympathy and empathy he can get. But he can't go ahead and extend that to somebody else. Alright.
That sounds... Hopefully sounds good to you. Sounds great to me. Yeah, I know, because people are like, oh, Phil's angry. Yeah, because people do it on purpose. They irk me. Let's keep mentioning another streamer 4,000 times on Phil's stream, so Phil finally has to ignore or acknowledge it and derail his whole stream talking about it. Why the fuck?
What's going on? You're not doing shit. As far as I'm concerned, Mr. Papavera is the one that's at the wheel, and you're just there. You're just hooves pressing buttons. You're not doing a goddamn thing. So what's being derailed? How pathetic of an attention whore do you must be, that literally every waking moment of your stream has to be about you. When, if a meme popped up about Jordy, he'd laughed about that shit all the time, or all day. Especially if the stream is slow, which it usually is, and he needs something to talk about. He doesn't want to see anybody else do good. It doesn't, and even when he's doing good, he still don't want to see nobody else doing good. It's the most craziest shit. It really is. Tevin has pointed this out. How he just can't be happy for somebody else. It's just not in him. It's not in him to look at what somebody else is going through and being good or bad and either show some empathy or just be happy for them. It doesn't matter if you know them or not. It doesn't matter if you don't know them or not. Just say congratulations and move the fuck on. Come on, Phil, you're a liar. You've said a bunch of shit you don't mean. Just like how when Catherine makes the mashed potatoes with the skin still on it, and you were like, oh, that's really good, honey, I really appreciate it. Did you really mean it? Of course you didn't. Or that bland-ass chicken with little to any seasoning on it? It's probably still raw in the middle? Did you say that was pretty good eating? Yeah, you said it, but did you mean it? No, you didn't mean it. So what's the difference?
About some streamer who I don't know getting engaged. Why do I give a fuck about any of that? Why do you bring him up? Why can't you just shut the fuck up about it and grow the fuck up about it? You know? It's ludicrous. How obsessed you fucking people are with other streamers and shit. It's not healthy behavior at all. It's really not. It's fucking disgusting.
It's not healthy to be obsessed with another streamer. This is coming from an individual, ladies and gentlemen, who wants you guys to watch his videos on YouTube. Remember, you guys need to step up. On YouTube. You guys need to step up. I need that ad revenue because I'm going to lose my fucking house. So you need to step the fuck up. Oh, and also, don't forget to use the link down here to give me money directly, especially if you can't come on the streams. Don't forget that. This is the same idiot who has encouraged people to still tip him or send him bits even if he's not streaming. You know what I'm saying? Looking at you, Golden Colts. You know what I'm saying? That's a thing, right? It's the same guy who expects you to go ahead and be all on his fucking virtual dick on Twitter and whatnot, and look at his and look at the schedule, no matter how much it changes, and show up to the pre-streams so you can get what's going on. And then on top of that, ladies and gentlemen, on top of the pathetic begging that he does, right? All the snorting and belching and the bottle crunches and all that silly shit, right? This idiot right here comes up with a new excuse multiple times in a year on why you need to give him money. And if you don't, he's going to go away. And you are going to be poor for it. Somehow your life is going to lose value if you don't watch Darkseid Phil for another day. If he's forced to get a 9-to-5 job. If he can even get that. If he starts streaming less, all of a sudden your world's going to crumble. But yeah, he talks about people being obsessed. When in actuality, he wants people to be obsessed with him. He wants people to be invested in him. He wants people to be concerned with him. He wants people to cater to him and be there for his every whim. Whether financially, whether emotionally, whether to combat trolling. And now another stream is being brought up, Wings of Whoever. And now we got an attitude about it because you're going to talk about another streamer on my stream. Mr. Oh, well, some of these streamers out here, man, you know, I don't agree with what they do. You know, I feel like they're being dishonest. I feel like, you know, they're not presenting a quality product. I feel like they just have kids over there and they just take advantage of them and that's it. Which is ironic because this is coming from the same individual who says he doesn't watch other streamers. So how the fuck do you know how someone else conducts their own business if you don't actually have time to watch it? Oh, are you getting cucked by Catherine again? Because she's watching other people's playthroughs and not yours because she realizes it's garbage? But then again, she married a trash fire, so you would think she'd be accustomed to that. But whatever, every woman makes mistakes, right? It is what it is. Or almost every woman, anyway. So, you know, that's semantics. Actually, she got you so cucked, Phil, that now she got you watching other people's playthroughs. That's amazing, because Phil says he doesn't watch other people. He doesn't watch other people's content. He's only focused on his own. But now, all of a sudden, ladies and gentlemen, games that are coming up upon request just happen to be games that he's been watching other people play through. Well, that's curious. That's semantics. I'm sure there's no connection at all, right? Not at all. It's not a Theo theory or anything. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Wink.
I'm a man of the people. I'm not about being an elitist and being a big man that popular...
Yeah, you're definitely not a big man. I've already talked to Panda about that. You definitely couldn't measure up, so it's okay. Not every man's built the same. Well, man, pig.
Oh, giant celebrities want to watch. I'm about the common people. The common gamer.
The peasants, you mean? Because that's kind of what he means when he says that. He's about the peasants. He's about the misfits. He's about the people who have nowhere else to go and they only feel like they can only be related to and understood by Darkseid Phil. It's really sick when you think about it. An individual who preys upon other individuals who have either mental or physical disabilities that he can prey upon and has done it his whole career. I think that's kind of sick. I think that's a fucking problem. But whatever, you know, don't listen to me. I don't have any morals.
That's what I've always said that I was or felt that I was. I told you I never felt that I was ever better than any of you guys.
You demanded people to give you money and you demanded people to step their shit up on YouTube or you would end up having to quit archiving your stuff there, which made no sense. But you never thought you were better than them. Oh, guys, I need your help. I need this money for taxes. I need this money for overdraft fees. I need this money for groceries. I need this money for my back taxes. I need this to pay my tax attorney. I need this to pay my bankruptcy attorney. I need this money to pay in advance to my tax preparator because now he wants his money up front. But I never thought I was better than anybody else. Okay, sure. That makes total sense. Who was I to even question that, ladies and gentlemen? I'm so sorry. I'm not sorry.
$3, so why are you talking bad about your fans? We all love you. Because I'm not necessarily talking about people who are actual
Look
fans.
Look at how he backed that up. See how quickly that bacon shriveled? That's how you know, ladies and gentlemen, that it was more fat than meat and it wasn't really worth it. Womp womp.
I'm talking about these tweeners, these people who are here only to basically deride or derail the stream.
What the fuck is a tweener? Did Phil, I'm going to talk to you directly for a minute. I had heard that Catherine said that you weren't really measuring up and she had to bring out the tweezers on you. Is that the case, Phil? You can tell me. You can tell me. You really can. I mean, I, you know what I'm saying? I can't relate to it. I don't understand that. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't know. But I can try to show you some sympathy. Is that what it is? You can tell me. You can tell me, Phil. You're not measuring up? Comes, I mean, let's be honest, ladies and gentlemen. He lost his endurance a long time ago. He lost that Italian stallion, you know what I'm saying? Endurance, he lost that a long time ago. And he lost the drive, too. Ex-Panda, she'll tell you. So now he ain't measuring up, and now Catherine has to go to outrageous lengths. Outrageous lengths, that's funny. Anyway, she has to go to outrageous measures to get his length to measure up. It must be hard to be dealing with a cocktail weenie. Can you even call it a sausage at that point? Yikes. DSP News, so hurtful. So hurtful.
People who literally do this on purpose. Again, why are you bringing up this guy? Because they want to get a rise on me. They want me to derail what I'm doing on my stream and not concentrate on the game and instead get angry and get
You busy. Really need to concentrate on Minecraft? Running around looking for... What was he looking for, ladies and gentlemen? He's looking for a turtle and has been doing it for the last two streams? How much concentration are we really putting into this? Alright.
Stop about people talking about other streamers. That's number one, against the rules. Number two, insanely...
It's against the rule until we bring up LSB, who's been making a name for himself over there as of late, Tevin, and Wings. But it's you know, it's against the rules, though. It's against the rules. Snort in, snort out.
Sure, and ludicrous that you would fucking do that. Spartan King Sheer. I don't get why people come to your streams to talk about Wings. No one fucking cares about him. He's not entertaining. I'd rather watch paint dry. And here's the thing. It's not even about that. I know nothing about the fucking guy. If you're so obsessed with this fucking guy, go to his fucking stream to talk about him. It's disrespectful to flood someone else's stream and have everything you talk about is another person. Oh, this, all that. Like, it's this weirdo lolcow culture. Alright, lolcow, lolcow, however the fuck you say it. It's a weirdo culture. It's a bunch of fucking no-life idiots who fucking get into this culture. Who your life fucking sucks shit. So what you gotta do is find someone who you think that their life sucks too, so that you can make fun of them constantly so you feel better about yourself.
You mean like how I used to run around making fun of people too? And how Mr. Oh, I outlasted them. I'm still here and they're not? And you're pretty much the king of the lol. Well, I don't know if I say you're the king of the lol cows. You're the pet pig of the lol cows, maybe. Something like that. But that's exactly what you are. That's your reality. You're the one that's mad that you can't be taken seriously, as if taking you seriously was a good idea in the first place. That didn't make too much sense either which way. This is your reality, buddy. You're going to have to deal with it. It's one of the reasons why you said that you can't get you won't be able to get a real job. Which, that's your fault, ass clown. You didn't have to treat people like garbage. You didn't have to treat people like they were beneath you. You chose to. You thought you were entitled to. And now, here's what the consequences are. You thought you were going to come in and just shit it up. And then you were going to walk away clean? Theoretically, no one in this whole DSB sphere of nonsense, whether you're a detractor or a pay piggy, is going to ever walk away from this clean. That's one of the arguments that's being made on Kiwi Farms. Quick detour, ladies and gentlemen. So, because, you know, we're into our second round of drinks. I'm still paying, so, you know, order what you like. So, someone had asked, do I feel that it was right for Gamer J Lee to get doxxed? My initial thing on doxxing is no. I don't feel that Gamer J Lee should have gotten doxxed. Now, the argument that's being made on Kiwi Farms is that his information was already publicly known. It was already out there. It's on his social media. Someone just brought it together. The other argument is, why are we doxing Gamer J Lee? He didn't do anything wrong, so to speak. I'm sorry. I'm trying to be serious. He didn't do anything wrong. So why do we feel the need to categorize him and put all of his information out there, even though it is already out there? The argument that's being made against that is, well, it's not a problem when we go ahead and dox DSP's... his lolcow, you know, the people who orbit him, you know what I'm saying? His fans, you know, his paid piggies, the assholes who really step out of line. It's okay if, you know, those people get exposed, but we're not, we have someone who's getting a lot of attention off of DSP because of his current situation. So, you know, why can't he be subject to it just like anybody else? My initial thing is this. I don't condone doxing at all. I've just never been one for that. It is what it is. That's just my opinion, of course. But I've never, excuse me, I'm sorry. I've never condoned that. At the end of the day, though, you're going to do what you want to do. I will also say that by that proxy, we can't sit here and pick and choose who gets doxxed and who don't. We can't do that either. Either A, we stop doing it altogether. Or B, and this is kind of the sad part of it all, really, but it's the reality, everybody's up for grabs. That's just the reality. Now, I would prefer that we just didn't do it. You know what I'm saying? If now, granted, if someone wanted to be a total fucking asshole and wanted to really go ahead and go to that bullshit and go to that level, like, and want to start doxing people themselves, I can't think of the guy's name right now. I think it was KG, but don't hold me to that. Somebody over there and on Phil's side of it used to do that. He still has people trying to do that. I think Swaggins was participating in that for a while. It is what it, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can't, one side can't be all virtue and the other side gets to play dirty. And at the end of the day, we're all up for grabs. So either A, we stop it altogether, right? We stop it altogether, or B, it is what it is. That's the best I can give you. I don't condone it. I don't think there's a need for it. You know what I mean? And there's been a lot of people who got hit. And I know that there was a real big thing around the time Papa Vera got hit. Because they were like, Papa Vera never did anything. He's always really just been subservient to DSP. Why did he get his shit put out there? I don't know. I can't tell you. I wouldn't know. You know what I'm saying? I don't have an issue with Papa Vera except for the fact that I wish he went ahead and just did his own shit. Because it's obvious the guy's talented. And he's wasting his talent on Phil. But at the same time, that's his time. He can do whatever. He can spend his time, you know, working out these elaborate blueprints for Phil, just like I'm going to waste my time doing this, if one would consider it a waste of time. But I like what I do. And obviously, he likes what he does. And at the end of the day, whatever you're going to do, make sure that your next move is your best move. And before anybody can put value on what you do, you have to have value on it. You have to enjoy it. If not, what the fuck are you doing it for? And I thought Papa Vera was starting to come to that realization, but whatever. But that's my issue on that. Do I think he should have gotten hit? No. I don't think Gamer Jay Lee should have gotten hit. But from what I've been told, Gamer Jay Lee's stuff is already out there. It's just been kind of consolidated and categorized. Did it need to happen? No, but it did. And like I said, we can't pick and choose who gets it and who don't. We all have blood on our hands. Whether you've doxed anybody or not. We all kind of have blood on our hands, so to speak, like to a degree, if you will. Don't you know? I don't mean to kind of lump all of us into the same boat. I don't mean to do that. My apologies. But you can't pick or choose. Either we choose to stop doing it, right? Or just everybody's up for grabs. And Kiwi Farms, if I'm sure some of you have read the threads and whatnot, they're kind of just observers. Not all, at least some of them. Not all of them are on one side or another. A lot of them kind of have, they just look at it as, they look at all of us as just fucking spurgs and loyal cows and shit. Well, not loyal cows, Phil's the cow. But they look at all of us as spurgs and they just laugh at all of us. It is what it is. They don't have a side. And because they don't have a side, they can do what they want. They're kind of outside the rules of what it is and what it isn't. That's my hard snort take on that. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to break the flow with a more serious topic, but someone did ask, and I figured that I at least give you at least what I think, for whatever that's worth. DSP news.
It's fucking sick. It is. If you follow people around just to make fun of them constantly and you call them a lolcow, you're a sick fuck. You're actually fucked in the head. All right? It's not normal behavior. You should be looking for constructive things.
Is it normal behavior to sit there and snort and belch and fucking and basically waste away every day? Has any of you guys seen the 10-year video that Mighty D did I've been meaning to do it. But I want you guys to think about what he says is normal behavior. And look at him over the last 10 years and how he wasted away. I'm going to do that video. I'm going to go over it. And then I want you guys, and the theme will be, ladies and gentlemen, I want you guys to see what normal behavior looks like. And watch how the years have treated him. Watch how he wasted away. And yet he still thought he was in the right. From the time that he allegedly hurt his back and could have had surgery to fix it but didn't want to, all the way to this bullshit now where he fucking, his latent mutant abilities kicked in when he came to Seattle, and he formed extra muscles around his baby backs to strengthen it, and now he doesn't need back surgery anymore. But he can't drive long distances, though. And he can't lift anything over 25 pounds upstairs without his little hand cart. But that's normal, though. It's normal to live like a fucking sloth. It's normal to be a slug. It's normal to have other people just drive you around because you can't drive long distances because of your back. What the fuck are you doing in the car? Why can't Catherine go out and do the shopping on her own? Why can't Catherine go off and do all the errands on her own? It seems to me like you're not really that hurt. Just my opinion, though, of what's normal. DSP News.
Online, not to bring down other people constantly. And that's all that culture is. It's disgusting. It's the essence of fucking immaturity and just disgusting, lowest level human behavior. That shit. And you gotta cut the fuck out. Because that's all it is. People, I'm so infatuated. Low cow. I gotta come to a stream and talk about it. And blah, blah, blah. Shut the fuck up. No one cares about your stupid shit.
Now, here's another thing, too. This all started, ladies and gentlemen, with a person asking him, hey, are you happy for Wings? Or what do you think about Wings getting married? He relegated Wings to a lol cow and then said people were obsessed with him and then said how it's unfair to obsess about lol cows. So you guys see how he took the narrative of something positive that, hey, Wings is getting married. Are you going to congratulate him? Turn him into a lol cow. Turn him to his point of focus and then project his frustrations with being project his notions, his frustrations about being looked at as an ass clown who can't be taken seriously, who's a liar, who has nothing of worth to give or to say. And he's doing all that through Wings because he's not man enough to go ahead and say it himself. He's not man enough to put his piggy titties out there and go ahead and say, you know, I'm tired of what you people are doing to me. He has to use Wings as his point of projection. Yikes.
You and your little circle-jerking community of idiots who think that you're so cool because you talk about these fucking people and obsess over them and you hound them and you harass them and you make that the entirety of your existence.
I'll say this right now. He doesn't want no problems with Wings' trolls. DSP really don't. He don't want no problems with those people. He really don't. Because they are about that life. If DSP thinks he has it bad now because his little social, you know, persona, which don't mean shit anyway, is getting torn down, he don't want that shit to come to his fucking front door. He really don't. And a Wings detractor is all about that life. They'll bring it there. At least some of them will. They are really about that life. So if I was him, I'd settle that shit down. I'd settle that shit the fuck down unless he's ready for everything else that comes with it. Because right now, he's sitting there... Excuse me. Right now, he's kind of just dangling on the tip. He don't want to end up just falling over. Because after that, there ain't no coming back. And the way Phil's spurging out now, because it's obvious he's losing it. Like, he's losing it really, really big with this whole foreclosure and bankruptcy thing. He don't need a couple of Wings trolls coming over here and tipping him over the edge. And they're relentless. And they will bring the fight to his fucking doorstep. And Catherine and Jasper can be damned because, oh well, they're collateral damage. We were only aiming for DSP. We didn't actually aim for them. But, oh, they were in the way, so they could take it too. Because if they would put Wings's aunt or aunt, however you want to word it, Harriet, and then his grandmother, if they were willing to put them in the line of sight, so to speak, to get Jordy, then who's to say that Catherine and Jasper can't get it? Don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to demonize them or anything. I'm just saying, if you guys have watched any Wing content, you can get an idea of what links these guys are willing to go to. Especially if they feel like they've been provoked. DSP don't want that. He really don't. So that's my only warning. After that, I'm just here to report. DSP news.
Fucking loser. Not the person you're making as pathetic and as low as the person you're making fun of. If you, is that the be all end all of your existence, you're actually lower than them. Understand that. You are lower than them. You are a lower form of life than the Blau cow that you profess to make fun of because you made your whole life about obsessing about that person.
Because someone makes videos or they restream you, that's their whole fucking life? How retarded is that? Who are you trying to convince, man? Me or yourself, dog? Like, seriously, like, who are you really trying to convince with this? Because it sounds like you're trying to convince yourself. And it's really pathetic, by the way. It's a real pathetic attempt. It's really sad. It's really silly. It's really silly. You put yourself out there publicly, yeah? And you do it for profit, yeah? That means you're fair game to whatever ridicule that comes your way. And outside of anybody bringing the fight to your doorstep, as we already spoke about, you're fair game. Especially if you want to treat people like shit. It's funny how he wants to treat people the way he wants to treat them, but he don't want no blowback for it. He don't want no one to stand up for them. He don't want no one to say nothing about it. It's his stream. He wants to just let that shit go along. Then just have private streams then, bitch. And see where that gets you. But see, you don't want to do that because you're not going to make no money in that. Just like how Gross Gore thought that shit was a real good idea too until he realized, you know what, I'm not going to make any money doing that. Especially with the games that he plays. Because a lot of people have intellectual patents they have intellectual terms of service on their games that if you were to hold a private stream, which means it's literally like, let's say it was a sub-only stream and no one else can see it, whatever, you can't play certain games by certain you can't play certain games by certain publishers if you decide to do that. Guess who's on that list, ladies and gentlemen? Just about everything. Just about every publisher is on that list. Just about. Some indie games you could get away with. But other than that, and there might be a few mainstream games you could probably get away with. But other than that, everybody's on that. Meaning that, no bitch, you're not going to go ahead and have a private session and get all that money and profit. Nah, if you're going to play our games for a living on YouTube or on Twitch, you're advertising for us, you're billboards, and a billboard doesn't think. It does. So get the fuck out there and do. And then Gross Gore and end up shutting his mouth and be like, whatever. You know, maybe I'll just do a Q&A or some shit. So it's amazing how people like that back down. If Phil really wants to go ahead and be about that life, then go ahead and hold a private stream. Do that shit and see how far it gets you. Because I guarantee you the little 300 people that you have up there, 350, if I'm being generous, would probably dwindle down to about 100 plus. Maybe. Even with all the gifted subs that are passed out in that bitch. Something to think about.
Like an idiot. So, congratulations, you're lower than the person who you think is the lowest of the low. And you don't even realize it because you're so ignorant and stupid in your own fucking head. You don't have
this is coming from the same idiot who used... That went to the bank and got business loans for a YouTube channel. And did it twice. Matter of fact, he did it three times with Panda, but... Whatever. He's still paying on two of them. He did it twice. This is the same ignorant bastard who sat on his pork butt and ended up having a piece of property go into foreclosure because this idiot didn't want to pick up the phone. Okay. This is the same idiot, ladies and gentlemen, who's going into... Sorry, he's going... Yeah, he went into foreclosure because he didn't want to fucking answer the phone. We have an idiot who's getting ready to go bankrupt because this ass clown didn't want to pay his bills. But he wanted to go out and eat good... And get gout and have a failing business and not basically curb his lifestyle, which is what it comes down to. He didn't want to curb his lifestyle because if he did, if he had to change the way he had to live, then he would have to accept the fact that he's failing. He thought, oh, I'll beg more. No, well, he's always been begging, but I'll beg more directly on Twitch and then that'll be my supplemental income and never paid his bills. Think about that, ladies and gentlemen. Think about that. You have a group of people who make fun of Phil for the lulz, or point out his bullshit, or make his shit palatable for everybody else. You know what I'm saying? God bless Mighty D. God bless Snor Pernell. God bless Mr. Huffstuff and individuals like that. David Davidson. You guys know the list. Who go through the painstaking process of having to deal with that nonsense so you guys can get 10 or 15 minutes of fucking greatness. Right? Because this ass clown can't do it himself. But all of us, though, we're idiots. All of us are too fucking ignorant, to get it through our heads that, oh, you shouldn't laugh at someone's misfortune. Coming from the same clown, the same cuck, who sats there and does that shit on a regular basis. Especially if the person's bigger than him. I mean, then again, it's not like his wife is his wife. He share her. So I guess you got to do what you got to do. I guess you got to get a W the any way you can get it, right? DSP News?
Life of your own. All you do is harass the fucking person. It's true. It's absolutely true. It's really fucking dumb. There's just too many dumb fucking people on the planet at this point. Really, there just are. The problem is that
there are too many people on the planet. So if we're gonna go ahead and if we're gonna go to this level, ladies and gentlemen, if we're gonna go to this level where we need to start exterminating people because there's too many people on there, I'm gonna be realistic with you guys, ladies and gentlemen. The weak are gonna go first. So what number do you guys think Phil's gonna be? Just out of curiosity. Anybody? Anybody at all? I mean, what skills does Phil provide in this brave new world if we decided to go ahead and liquidate some of the excess that we're holding on to? Now, and also, and I want you guys to really, really think about this. We have an individual right now who is relegating just about everybody down to the basic common denominator. He's basically saying there are people out there who don't have any worth in life and they should go. They need to, it's time for them to go ahead and, you know, be expunged for the greater good. So where does Phil fit in that narrative? What side of that is he going to be on? I want you to think about that. We have a Let's Player whose life is falling apart because he's a fucking ass clown. He's an asshole. He's an ignorant bastard who was never taught how to manage money. You know what I mean? Who ran around for years parading himself like he had a business and he didn't. He really didn't. He was just some ass clown on YouTube who made a bunch of money off a bunch of kids who didn't know fucking better. That's really what it was. That's really what the situation is. That's what happened. Who ran around and paraded himself as a business until and was taking out business loans, was asking for business deductions until the state of Washington came knocking and was like, hey, you owe us business and occupation. You owe us state and business occupation tax, Phil Brunell. We'll be expecting a check. Oh, you owe us for the last 3 years, by the way. Oh, but I'm not a business. Oh, really? Then why is it that you're filing for business expenses and exempting certain stuff on your taxes that you say are business related, Phil? That didn't make a whole lot of sense. I said that when that first came out. How the fuck are you going to claim yourself to be a business and writing stuff off on your taxes as business expenses, but you're not a business? How does that work? That was strange. But we're the ignorant ones. We're the ignorant ones. People who get up every day, who go to school, who go to work, who pay their obligations. While this idiot right here wants to sit down and play video games all day and be paid for it, but doesn't want to pay for any of his obligations. The same ass clown who wants to sit there and frivolously spend money on shit that he don't need, and most of the time he doesn't even want, just so he can do it. The same ass clown that has to take days off on Tuesdays because mommy and him used to go shopping on Tuesdays. So Catherine isn't even his wife or his soulmate. She's just another woman to take the place of his mother. But we're the ignorant bastards, though. The same guy who sits there and says, you guys have no right to put his life under a microscope and dissect it, despite the fact that he put his life out there under that microscope to be dissected for profit. Oh, well, he did it for entertainment purposes, GTG. You're being an asshole about it. This is my entertainment. If I was going to watch the video anyway, then why shouldn't I sit here and dissect it? That's two birds with one stone. Or that's two piggies in a blanket, if you will. And if he can't justify why he can't take games seriously, and he can't play them at least somewhat competently, then who the fuck has to justify anything to him about the content that they make or the jokes they make about him online? What sense does that make? Oh well, we'll reconvene in a little while. DSP News.
There's so many people, there's only a limited amount of resources on the planet, and there's so many people on the planet who sadly don't feel like they have meaningful lives, so they have to latch on to others, whether for positive or negative ways, you know what I mean? It's not healthy at all to be seeing. My entirety of the entertainment I get is by latching on to another person and hounding them constantly about every possible little fucking thing. Like, that's not a healthy life at all. That's a completely disgusting, toxified, mentally ill, fucked up way to exist. And there are a ton of people that live like that in this on this planet right now. That's not good. You know, that's
So because there's limited resources and you got a bunch of people that are toxified, they deserve to be killed. They deserve to be done away with. So what? So we can have a bunch of ass clowns like you sucking up even more resources and not contributing to anything? Don't get me wrong, Phil. You breeding is not a good idea, to be honest. I've been the first person and maybe the only person that's ever said your mom should have swallowed or your father should have pulled out. And I stand by that. Sorry. Look at what you came out as. I mean, And since you're already going to pretty much kill off your family bloodline anyway, at least, well, for your dad anyway, your uncle. I don't think your uncle had sons, now I think about it, because you have, I think you said all your cousins are female. I mean, it's not that a woman can't carry the name. Whatever. That's semantics. I'm starting to, we're deep diving into some shit that doesn't really even matter, to be honest. But you don't need to be procreating anyway, so that's whatever. But he's literally sitting here and telling you guys, ladies and gentlemen, that, you know, you guys who laugh at him, as well as the people who make content on him, maybe we don't deserve to be around anymore. Maybe space is getting limited, and Phil's clean air is starting to be sucked up, and maybe something needs to happen to us. That's what he's implying, basically. That's basically what he's implying, which is a wild thing to say, ladies and gentlemen, from someone who's, you know, half passed from being fucking homeless, possibly. For everything that he allegedly worked for over the last 11 plus years is going to be taken away from him. And now all of a sudden he's talking about worthless people who probably shouldn't be around anymore because resources are getting limited. Like, if a bunch of us died off, ladies and gentlemen, he would somehow be able to keep his house. Wild way of looking at it. But, you know, I'll leave that up to you, though. I'll leave that up to your imagination. That's just my thoughts on it. Some really sad shit. From a man who looks like he's already dead. Or he's certainly dying. To sit there and to ponder the existence of other people. Just because they had a critical opinion of him. What about all the times he shit on PewDiePie? Excuse me. What about all the times he shit on PewDiePie? What about all the times he shit on Ninja? What about all the times he shitted on anybody who was more popular and more successful than him? Would he think that then? Would he think that, you know what, maybe you're a waste of fucking space, Phil. Maybe you should do something about that. Or maybe someone else should do something about that for you. Was that ever a thought that came in his mind? No, not at all. Only when Phil was on the chopping block. Only when you had some cute pup in a sharp suit that was making, excuse me, BLTs out of his ass and whatnot. Sweet and spicy BLTs, by the way. That, you know, all of a sudden something should be done. You know, maybe those people don't deserve to be around anymore. Well, that's not sick behavior at all. That sounds very rational, ladies and gentlemen, doesn't it? Doesn't that sound like what a normal person would say? There's too many people on the planet. Resources are getting low. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, oink, oink. That sounds real normal. That sounds real stable, to be honest. Just something to think about. DSP News.
Not good at all. Can I make Minecraft positive again or chill again one day? Says PW Dubs.
The thing is, I'm chill right now. I actually am chill.
Like, I enjoy talking about topics very matter-of-factly, and being able to do this actually makes me feel better to actually talk with you guys honestly about stuff.
If it makes you feel better that there's too many people on the planet and there's not enough resources, and laughing at other people's failure just so you can get over. Like this is like an impact wrestling promo or some shit. That right there makes him feel better. Okay.
Yes, it does. Like I actually feel very chill. Just because I elevate my voice a bit to make a point doesn't mean that I'm not chill at all. Like I actually I'm having a lot of fun tonight, despite the fact we still didn't find this stupid turtle. What I honestly think is I struck a nerve with certain people now. Oh, look, Phil's saying and doing, he's raging. No, I'm not raging. I'm actually telling you like it is. And you're probably thinking in your head, you're realizing that you're a loser because you're a Lao Cal fanatic. And now you feel like a fucking idiot. So now you're going to act like I'm the one that lost control tonight when in reality is you realizing how dumb you actually are.
No, I don't think you lost control. I think that's who you really are. I'm just kind of glad that you brought it out. It kind of makes my job just that much easier, to be honest. There's nothing to be mad about. I expect you to be a Spurg, which I'm a Spurg too, but I expect you to be a Spurg. I expect you to throw temper tantrums. I expect you to be a bitch. I can already smell the bitch on you, so, you know, the least you could do is bring the bitch out. Just saying. I can smell it on you. I can see it in you. You might as well bring it out for everybody else. So, no, not at all. Please continue. It's just so viably. It's so viable content. It's great. It's absolutely amazing.
You know?
Well, that gives a whole new term to spanking the monkey.
You're not a Lao Cal fanatic, great. You know? Good for you. But for the idiots who come to my stream and want to hound about another fucking streamer and just be a disgusting, toxic person all the time, I mean, sorry about your moment of self-realization and you feel like a complete worthless tool now, but it's kind of true. Oh, let's see here. Hard apple juice. Timmy Dollar says, but don't you think that talking about him for 2 to 4 minutes every time someone mentions his name is derailing your stream more? No, I don't. The thing is, you don't understand. Just
No, I don't think it's wrong that I bring him up and then Spurg out on him for X amount of minutes and whatnot. Because one, someone asked me about him, so that's my justification. Two, this is my stream, bitch, so I'm going to do whatever the fuck I want. And this is the quality content that you guys come here for. Three, you guys are all stupid kids anyway who don't know shit about the world. That's why you guys are here. That's why you guys look up to me. That's why I relegate you guys to stupid kids. Because you guys are all stupid fucking kids. And I know what's best for you. Get mommy's credit card ready. Hi, Derek. Bye, Derek.
Because I'm doing a Minecraft stream and now I bring it up for 2 to 4 minutes and I address it. You have to understand that like a giant portion of my entire day is idiots talking about this guy. Constantly. Just wings. Like, shut the fuck up. You're like a little incessant 5-year-old pulling at their parents' leg. Mommy, bothering about some of the dumbest shit. That's what it's like. And like, these are adults doing it in my stream chat. So I actually ignore it about 99.9% of the time. And then every once in a while, it'll get to me to the point where I bring it up. And now all of a sudden, Phil, you... By the way, there's the bird statue, so I know the village is over there. That's pretty awesome. Right? Phil... You really let yourself go to talk about that today. It's like, no, I ignored it 99.9999 times, and I finally addressed it once. That's not the case. So if you think...
No, it is the case, because, one, you should just... If you've ignored it 99.999999 times, then who's to say just letting it go altogether? See, you're not man enough to do that. You're not mature enough to do that. You don't have enough discipline to do that. So because of that, when you do spurg out, or whatever... When you do go on your angry oinks and snorts, everybody else wins. You don't realize that, Phil. That's like you saying, oh, I am the best Street Fighter, Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo player ever, but yet he gets the Evo and he loses every year. It's okay that he can beat everybody at his locals, ladies and gentlemen. It's okay he can beat everybody at the little game shops that he used to go to. That's good for him. Lucky him that he was able to win those local tournaments. Lucky him that he was able to win Evo qualifiers. But when it came to the big dance, he couldn't get it done. Like what he couldn't do with Panda. He just couldn't get it done. So that's what people judge you on. He wants the accumulation of all of his acts to count. But when it needs to matter, he can't show. He can't deliver. And if you can't deliver, then who gives a fuck? See how that works, Phil? That's how failure plays in. So you harping on, like pathetic shit. Like, oh, I was the number one ranked American Super Turbo player in 2005, and you took fourth, and you really wanted people to acknowledge you for that, was by far one of the saddest things that anybody's ever heard. It's one of the laughing points in the FGC. If you had done that today, in 2020, if he pulled that at Evo, that's actually coming up, he'd be laughed right out of the FGC. He'd be laughed right the fuck out of the FGC. He would be ridiculed, and people would take his game footage and microanalyze that shit, which I need to do that too. But they'd microanalyze his fucking gameplay footage and break down each and every one of his flaws. And then, what would hurt even more, they would go ahead and show you why he lost at Evo. They would break that shit down. Esports.com and all those other different esports writers would all fucking have a field day with that shit. Because, hey, look at this idiot right here who took fourth, but says he was the number one ranked player that year. Or this year. You know how much people would clown him for that? Ernesto Lopez Jr.? You know what I mean? The guy who does Button Check. I've talked about him quite a bit. He would definitely have a segment on Button Check for that shit. Hopefully Horny Tuesdays. He should do it on there because that'd make it even funnier. But he would definitely have a segment laughing at that. Twitter'd have a field day with that shit. And I'm talking about regular Twitter. I'm talking about FGC Twitter, not even Detractor Twitter. He'd be laughed the fuck out for that. That's the reality, ladies and gentlemen. You don't get to win a few battles and say you won the war. You gotta win them all. You gotta win them all. And if you can ignore something 99 point whatever, then you would think you could just let it go. You would think that's where the reality is. You could just let it go. But you can't. And that's why we're at where we're at now. Just my opinion, of course, though. DSP News.
I think that actually being matter of fact about something and having, you know, the freedom to talk about something very matter of factly like that is wrong, then you're at the wrong place. You really are. You're the wrong stream, the wrong place. That's who I am. That's who I always have been. I'm not going to sugarcoat shit. If you're allowed...
And look at where I got him. Just want to throw that out there, too. For clarification's sake, of course.
Kyle Fanatic, you're a fucking loser in life, and you need to get the fuck off my stream.
Coming from another loser who's going to lose everything. Coming from another loser that suckled at mommy and daddy pretty much his whole goddamn life. Someone who's 37, right? 37... with this pathetic attempt of a makeshift family, with a declawed cat, right? A woman who I can only imagine what kind of baggage she's carrying. You know what I mean? Sorry, cat. You know, I just got to throw it out there. I won't throw out what your baggage is, but I'm going to throw that out there. And he wants to call that a life. All this shit that he manufactured, it didn't happen organically. He made it happen to try to prove a point. He thinks he's something. He thinks because he has this in hove, he thinks he's winning. Who all of his past accomplishments don't mean jack shit. Let's be honest with each other, ladies and gentlemen. In 5 or 10 years, none of this is going to matter. If YouTube's even here in 5 or 10 years, this won't matter. Even when all this that, because a lot of you keep asking me if I'll put this on BitChute, which I will, goes to BitChute. In 10 years, none of this stuff will matter. At the end of the day, we're all going to be fleeting. You know what I mean? It is what it is. No one's going to remember. No one's going to care. It'll all just be archived. Maybe some of the stuff will get archived somewhere. Maybe 10, 15, 20 years from now, you know, people will find some Tevin videos and they'll laugh about it. But in reality, none of this is going to matter in another decade or two. Maybe. And Phil, if he thinks there's some type of resurgence that's going to happen for him, if he thinks there's going to be some type of resurrection, he's fooling himself. His run's over. It's always been over. There isn't going to be a second chance for him. There isn't going to be some type of Galtopian renaissance where all of a sudden things just start working his way. Because even if it did, he'd still figure out a way to fuck it up. That's the reality. Now here's what's going to hurt even more, Phil. You're a dinosaur. You're going to go extinct just like the rest of us. The only difference is the rest of us understand that and we're okay with it. You're not. You're irrelevant. You're going to be non-existent soon. Well, maybe not soon, but eventually, I should say. That's probably the better terminology. Eventually, you're going to be non-existent. And that's just the reality. No one's going to look back and look at you as, oh, he was the tragic hero of this situation, of this story. No one's going to do that. No one will ever do that. There will always be someone who's going to remember, oh, wow, you remember all those Tevin streams? Or those LSB streams? Or those Agent Proper videos and James Lester videos? Yeah, I remember those. And someone's going to dig them up if they don't already have them on a hard drive somewhere. And they'll just re-upload it wherever that goes. And eventually that will beat out whatever content that you have that exists. And this, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm speaking to you directly, Phil, this is all coming from an individual who has seen enough videos about all those external hard drives that you have to guess that at least a few of them have crapped out. At least. And you would think, for someone who spent all those years hoarding all of his content, that, you know, he would consider updating that onto newer hard drives, onto newer hardware every once in a while. Now, granted, most hard drives usually have a pretty good lifespan. The thing is, though, Phil is, well, you're Phil. And you have a tendency, a compulsion, if you will, of mistreating your shit. So, and then, on top of that, ladies and gentlemen, if you thought that was worse, it's not. Even if those hard drives do work, which, like I said, the majority of them probably will, you know? I mean, what do they have? Like, there's a standard 3 to 5 year warranty on stuff like that. Not as if you have any of that stuff anyway, but whatever. Even if he was to upload all of that to another site, let's say he had to start over. None of that shit's categorized. I doubt it. So just imagine this idiot trying to upload 70,000 plus videos onto a site. All out of order. None of them with titles. None of them with descriptions. None of them with tags. And he literally has to start over. It would take him months to do that. And do you think Phil's going to do that? No. He's just going to swamp it onto the website, put Dark Side Phil onto it, or DSP Gaming, or whatever, and he's going to move off of it. And guess what that's going to make it? Garbage. It's going to make it irrelevant. It's going to make it useless. It's going to make it irrelevant. It's going to make it a waste of space. It's going to make it irrelevant. Nothing will come out of that of value. Just saying. That's the reality. That's the reality. He's fighting a battle that he's already lost. He's fighting a battle he's already lost. And he's too ignorant to realize that he handed us the victory already. The game's over. The game's over. We're just watching you kind of wither away. Which probably gives most of you like a strange type of feeling watching someone slowly decrepit and decay. Because that's kind of what it is. You're just watching someone decay. The moment he loses that house, it's a wrap. It's game over. Now, most people would have it in them to be like, no problem, I can start over. Not Phil. Not Phil. No. You see Phil trying to go back to YouTube and trying to start over then? Because he would have to. He would really have to go back to YouTube and really put some effort into it. He can still have Twitch, but he'd have to go back to YouTube too. Because, you know, getting a job, a real job, is apparently out of the question. So then what? What other options does 38-year-old Phil have? Two houses end up going into foreclosure, or one house goes into foreclosure, the other one gets claimed. He's bankrupt, so he has no credit for like 7 to 10 years. By then, Catherine's smart enough to get up out of that situation and get Jasper out of that. So then he's alone. So where does he go, ladies and gentlemen? He can't stay in Seattle or in Washington. He has nothing there. So he has to go back home. So imagine 38, 39-year-old Dark Side Phil, DSP, Phil Brunel. I like that. It kind of rolls well with failure. So now we have 38, 39-year-old Phil Brunel at home, upstairs, in that chimney of a house, apparently. His words, not mine. Up in that room, which used to be his room, but it's the cat's room now. It's the cat's room now. Smelling like cat piss, and looking at his hooves and being like, what the fuck did I do wrong? How did I get here? I thought I spent my life trying to escape this, and I'm right back to it. Then what? Where's the BMW at? Where's the friends at? Where's the soulmate at? Where's the cat at? Then what? Where's all the money at? Where's your fucking... Where's your the people who love your content? Twitch loves me in my streams. Where's your YouTube fame at? Where's your fucking little YouTube plaque? Then what? Mommy and daddy are starting to get sick? Well, mommy and daddy are starting to get older. I.e., mommy and daddy are starting to get sick. Mommy and daddy are going to need you to drive them around. Go off, do the shopping for them. You'll probably have to help them with their laundry. You're probably going to have to drive them to doctor appointments. Then what? Now you're forced to take care of somebody else. Now, I bet you that herniated disc don't hurt so much anymore. Now you got to do all that driving for them. How are you going to have time to play all the new games, Phil? When mommy is breathing out of an oxygen tank and needs you to go and get that refilled. Or go downstairs and grab her medication because she can't walk down there. Or she needs you to help her change the channel if the remote in the... If the remote's, the battery in the remote ends up dying out. You're going to literally be at your parents' beck and call. Then what? This is the reality, ladies and gentlemen. You may not like it. You may not like how I deliver it, I guess. That's probably something to dislike. But that's the reality. That's what's going to happen. Well, more than likely. What, is he expecting his uncles and aunts to go over there and take care of his parents? That theoretically wouldn't be their responsibility. That would literally go... That right there would kind of be expected of their son to do. And at that point, they would be his only source of wealth. So then what? Just something to think about.
I don't deal with that shit. I don't want to deal with that shit. I don't want to have a part to do with any of that. And it's really
so you want to? Is that what Phil's gonna say? I don't want to deal with this shit. I don't want to deal with this shit. I don't want to part with that shit. That's not how reality works, pumpkin.
Toxic shit, and you need to grow the fuck up. I Killed Kenny says the reason people talk about wings is how you react to it. Wrong. They talk about wings because they want to talk about wings constantly because they're obsessed idiots. That's why. Again, I rarely will address anything about him. I will just pass it off, ignore it. This is a rare case where I decided to address it because I'm tired of my streams being fucking derailed. You're an idiot and you're wrong. Here we go again. Not healthy to sweet dollar and insult me, so go fuck yourself. All right. To adjourn this week's stream, all right, very briefly, I have something to say that I have kept to myself the entire week. I have laughed to myself the entire fucking week about this. I literally have not addressed it at all because I wanted to wait until this very moment to address it because I wanted to close this week's Minecraft stream with it because it was a big segment of last week's Minecraft stream. Okay, are you ready? So, ladies and gentlemen, last week, I had a case that I had addressed. We were talking about people who obsess and people who become obsessed attractors and stuff like that. It was one of the topics we talked about on Minecraft last week. And I had mentioned that in the past... There was a person who I had thought was a big fan of mine. I said they were a big fan of mine to the point where I had met them at a convention. I eventually let them be a moderator of mine. And then eventually things had like turned somehow in this person's head, like their opinion against me had turned. And I, without me even talking to anyone about this kind of stuff, and ever talking to this guy over the years, I apparently had found out this guy had become a detractor of mine. He really hated me and apparently just had a really changed opinion about me to the point where he joined detractor communities. He was talking shit about me on social media or whatever. Now, this is someone who I had not had any contact with for years, right? This is someone who, you know, at one point I just met once in real life. We had some interactions online. He said he wanted to be a moderator for me. He had moderated for me for a little bit. And then basically stopped moderating for me. And that was it. That's where we left it. I never talked to him for years. Next thing I know, this guy has become a detractor. And we had a conversation about, man, it's weird how people kind of get
almost indoctrinated into the detractor community who have been fans of mine over the years. It's weird because it has nothing to do with me. I didn't do anything to this guy. I never talked to him or nothing, right? So we did all this. Talked about this. It was a big segment.
This is this coming from the same person who cultivated a cult, quite literally, for over a decade. Over a decade. You have people that have been around, that are around now, that have been around for that long. Excuse me. And he wants to talk about detractors brainwashing people when he's literally the case study for it. That's why DSP Cult Leader exists. Well, yeah, basically. Whoever that individual was picked up on that early and made a whole bunch of content on it. But we're the ones that are the Charles Mansons and, the great cult leaders of the day. Jim Jones and so on and so forth.
Of last week's stream. And, you know, that was it. That's where I left it. Now, by the way, I should bring this up. I never brought up anyone's name. I never addressed a certain person. I just said this in general was someone, and this is a case point.
Okay, I already kind of see the setup. I'm sure most of you guys already see this too. Like, that's all this is. This is semantics. This is literally, it sounds like this is about to be a bait and switch.
This is a true story of something that happened. I purposely didn't want to call out a name because I'll be very honest with all of you. I didn't remember the name of the person or whatever who it was.
Well, then you kind of just killed your own argument with that because you can't say that, oh, I'm going to bring up this very specific example about a particular person. Someone comes and I don't mention his name because I didn't remember it. When, if I remember correctly, he said that he didn't want to bring that person's name out on purpose. He was trying to be, not, I wouldn't say quote unquote respectful, but he purposely didn't want to call that person's name out. It didn't have shit to do with I didn't remember his name. But whatever, let's continue.
Couldn't remember, and I know exactly what this person looks like, okay? But I can't for the life of me remember them, okay? And it's my fault, you know, it's been years and years. We're talking 7+ years or whatever. But, you know, I didn't want to say a name. I didn't want to call out someone like that on a stream or whatever. I made it just a very generalized story, okay? Well, guess what? I take my day off last week, and apparently some person on the internet says, Phil was talking about me on the Minecraft stream, and I'm going to make this really nasty video about why I hate Phil, and this is how I came to not like Phil, and blah, blah, blah. So, of course, everyone on my day off tries to harass me about it online. I ignore. All week, people have been spamming my stream chat, all right, about this guy who made this video about me, saying, oh, Phil talked shit about me on the Minecraft stream or whatever, and this is the truth. I hate him because of this and this and this or whatever. And, you know, and everyone's, oh, Phil got blasted by this former fan, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Here's how I'm going to end the stream. Ladies and gentlemen, that person who made that video is not who I was talking about last week at all.
That's a lie. I don't buy this for a second. I don't buy it for a second. Because the circumstances, ladies and gentlemen, from the week before was set up in such a way to where he can say what he wants about anybody, and it could literally be anybody. Like, it makes, no, I don't buy that for a second. I don't buy it for a second. And then you sat on it. Now, think about this. This is Dark Side Phil, DSP, you know what I'm saying? Pork bitch incarnate, who is quick to call some shit out on Twitter if he gets the chance, or in a pre-stream if he gets a chance. But he sat on this for a week. He sat on it from one Minecraft stream to another, knowing damn well he was going on his day off after this. So he can keep his name basically flowing and whatnot until he comes back on Wednesday, I guess. And now all of a sudden, this is the great, I gotcha. You know what this is, ladies and gentlemen? In a very pathetic sort of way. But then again, everything he says is pathetic. This is him trying to do the Escort Saga all over again. And we all know that because he's been clamoring about the Escort Saga for like the last like 8 months. About how, or ever since the seven years of debunking stream, whatever. We all remember that. We all remember that trash fire. That's what this is. This is dead weight. This is literally dead weight. And then for him to This is literally just him saying, I got you. And who's he going to convince? What evidence does he have? Is he going to go ahead and tell us who the person really was? Oh, well, he can't because he still doesn't remember his name. But he remembers what he looks like, though. Okay, so let's look at another scenario. Let's look at hypothetical pignosis. You know, this is our favorite game. So now we have a situation where Phil talks about an individual who met all these very particular criteria. Someone comes out and says, well, if you look at the time frame, that's me. And I can prove that's me because look at the timeline, and this is my history with Darkseid Phil. Phil hears this, sits on it for a week, and then comes back and says, oh, that person, that's not him. That's not him. I don't remember the guy's real name or the person's name, but it's not the guy who's out here saying it. And I sat on it for a week so I could laugh at you guys in the face or in your face. Now, we got some problems, though, ladies and gentlemen. One, how many, and I'm going to use Phil's terminology with this, how many kids did you meet at conventions and you interacted with? Like, how many kids did you meet up with in real life and you interacted with, Phil, at a particular, you know, convention? How many? And that also were big fans of yours and loved all your content and eventually became mods and then eventually fell out and whatnot because they grew the fuck up. How many? Hmm? That seems kind of strange. That seems kind of wild. That seems kind of eerie, to be honest. You got a grown-ass man hanging around a bunch of kids. You know? Needing them to build himself up. That seems kind of strange. But let's let him continue. Let that dance around in your noggin for a minute.
This is some other guy! Some other fucking guy who apparently has a bug up his ass about me? This is not who I was talking about. Like I said, I remember specifically who this person is. That was not...
How does he remember specifically who this person is when he doesn't know his name? Does he not know what specifically means? Just saying. If I can go ahead and tell you every inch of Panda, I guess that would mean I specifically know exactly what her measurements are. One could even say that I'm, you know, one could say, hypothetically, that, you know, I was rather intimate with that. Hypothetically. Right? Isn't that what specific means? You kind of know, you know? You kind of have the details down? That's how that works, champ. And this is the thing that he's not thinking about. So we have two people who fall into the same scenario who both turned against you. Two people who were as close to you as they could be who eventually turned their back on you. That's not exactly a very good track record. But let's go ahead and hear more of the pignosis, ladies and gentlemen. Just saying. Because, you know, Phil's going to keep it very specific for us.
Guy at all. So this is some other guy who's come out of the woodwork. Who's like, oh, it's me he was talking about and blah, blah, blah. And I'm watching the video. I'm like, I don't know who this is.
Ooh. All right. In addition to that. On Wednesday, I'll be stopping my gameplay a little bit early. Usually, I stop it around, I don't know, 6:30, 7 o'clock. I'll probably be stopping around 6-ish because Gamer Jay Lee, who is an avid viewer, a fan of mine, who I actually met at SGC, Screwtag Gaming Convention, if you don't know what that is, last year, wants to do a brief interview with me. It's like 30 minutes, just wants to ask me some questions. I've agreed to do that on Skype. I'm not sure how he's going to present that, if it's going to be a video on his YouTube channel, but once I get that information for you guys, I'll let you know. But that's going to be me doing that on Wednesday, and then whenever he makes it live, I'll obviously spread the information so that you guys can listen if you want to, okay?
Take a sip, bitch. This right here is all out of context. Mighty D should be ashamed of himself for doing this. He should be ashamed. This is all taken out of context. That's not even really the same Gamer Jay Lee. That's another Gamer Jay Lee, ladies and gentlemen. You guys didn't know? There's like multiple Gamer Jay Lees out there. How does... Oh, God, I'm joking. Excuse me. There's multiple Gamer Jay Lees out there. Multiple. How could Phil know that this guy is that same guy? No way. Even though the Gamer Jay Lee that we're talking about does have a picture with him and Phil... and a picture with him, Phil, and John. I mean, it's a coincidence, though. But this is terrible. This right here is misrepresenting the whole situation. Terrible. 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 But I condone it, though. I'm just joking. But, yeah. Really? This is what the excuse is, ladies and gentlemen? This is how pathetic it's become. That's not the guy. It's not the guy. When there's a shitload of evidence out there that that is the guy. Hmm. Seems weird. But whatever, let's continue. Take a sip, sleazy asshole. I wish I could say it in the I could say it in the same tone as the mobster from Home Alone. That should be godlike. Be godlike.
I know I did. This isn't who I was talking about. Like, look, I was like, are you kidding me? It was just hilarious. I'm watching. I'm like, what the fuck? So the whole week, I just said, I'm just going to keep it under wraps until we get a Minecraft stream again next week. And then I'm and then I'm just going to be like, I'm going to be honest. I don't know who the fuck that is. I don't know what's going on, who that is. But this is someone who took it upon themselves.
Who's he trying to, like, yet again, ladies and gentlemen? Like, who are you trying to convince with this? Like, I mean, are you just kind of happy that you made your $106 and that's it? You made your little bit, you know, you made your little begging quarter or your little betting quota, actually. Begging quota. And that's it? Like, what is this? This is really sad. This is really pathetic, Phil. Like, I would have expected better from you. I would have thought if you were going to sit on this for a week, you would have something to kind of back it all up. Oh, that's right. Phil doesn't need evidence because Phil's word is law in Galtopia. I gotcha. Oh, speaking of, big ups to Karma, the Karma Kid. Yeah, I saw your, I saw your comment. I don't know. I'm reference heavy, so maybe I'm not sure, but but big ups to you either which way, man. I need to message you on Twitter. Actually, I have a question. I have a couple questions, but I have a question for sure. I'll definitely hit you up. I'll definitely hit you up on DMs, on Twitter. But big ups to Karma Kid. But yeah, I would have expected better from Phil. You would think if you sat on this for an entire week, you would have something else. Instead of just coming out and saying, oh, that's not the guy. Prove it. Prove that that's not the guy. Give us something to back all that up. Oh, you can't because Phil snorts our law. Well, that means nothing to nobody. And yet again, this is the 7 years of debunking stream all over again. There's no evidence to any of this. Like I said, it was so vague that it could literally, that, you know what I'm saying, he can basically dictate and or push the goalpost back as far as he wants. And why even bother? We all know you're lying. Or if not, we all think you're lying. So who gives a shit? Like, it's things like this, ladies and gentlemen, that are these useless battles he chooses to fight. And all he's doing is racking up wins for the other side. He's getting nothing out of this. This provides nothing. This is quite frankly useless. Just another sad state of affairs. DSP News.
To make what I was talking about last week, their own person, like they owned it too. He's owning it. Like this is his personal story and shit. And I'm like, that is totally not the guy who I'm thinking of and who I'm talking about. This is someone else who literally wants to claim this identity. I don't know if maybe it's a similar story, but this is not who I was addressing on last week's stream. But do you see the point?
He wanted to claim somebody else's story despite the fact that this individual has proof. And this pig right here only has his snorts, which means nothing. It gets hurtful sometimes, ladies and gentlemen. It gets hurtful. Can't wait to get back to the old stuff because Jesus Christ, this is just getting. I mean, I admit that I reach quite a bit. You know what I'm saying? D dot all day sometimes, not all day, but I reach for sure. But not like this. Not like this. I don't. No one reaches like this. No one reaches like this. This is really bad. This is really, really bad.
That I try to make, if anything, just enforces my point. These people invent a narrative they literally invent a narrative as a reason to hate me. See, all these reasons why I hated Phil, and this just proves my point. But I wasn't talking about you. You're an idiot. You're an actor.
One, he didn't say he hated you. Two, you calling him an idiot doesn't solidify anything. It doesn't prove anything. If nothing else, it just kind of shows your resentment, which is counterintuitive to the message that you're trying to convey. You see what I'm saying about, you know, anybody who goes against his narrative automatically as a detractor? I talked about that in the last broadcast. You're seeing it right here in all of its glory. Smothered in grease. You're seeing it right now. So, ladies and gentlemen, how are you supposed to bring people to your side if the very people that you want to bring to your side, you're going to put down? Like, what sense does that make? And even if, for example, some of you who are just onlookers, if you were willing, even in the smallest of a narrative, if you were even willing to give Phil the chance, why would you do it now when he's already relegated all of you to the lowest common denominator? Yet again, this goes back to what Howard said about Phil has no PR ability whatsoever. He doesn't know how to talk to people. He doesn't know how to interact with people. He doesn't know how to handle a situation. His first basic instinct is to ridicule, is to put people down, because it's the only thing that gives him strength. I've said this before, but it's in his nature. You can't change that. Now, whether he's been on the opposite end of that, I couldn't tell you. I would guess he has, but he's using this as a coping mechanism. He always has, to be honest, and it's all he has. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is actually sad. And I don't mean sad in a pathetic type of way, despite the fact that it is sad in a pathetic type of way. But that's all he has. That's all he has. And sadly, ladies and gentlemen, nothing can change that.
Actual fucking idiot who made this about you when it was never about you. You're a complete moron. And this is hilarious about this shit, is that people do this all the time. Oh my god, Phil did this personally to me, but I didn't do anything. You made it.
Yeah, when was the last time someone came out and pulled a Gamer J Lee before Gamer J Lee? When was the last time that was? It's been a while, right? But it happens all the time, though. You know, just like how Phil says, oh, that was a million years ago, and a million years ago was like 6 months ago. Stuff like that.
You literally did it. You made that association yourself, so you have a reason to hate me. Like, this is what people do. This is how nuts these fucking people are, okay? So for me, like, I literally just laughed to myself all fucking week about this. And I was like, I can't believe how ludicrous this is, this guy saying all this shit. I'm like, this is not who I'm talking about. And again, I wouldn't, even if it was a specific person, I remember their name, I wouldn't call them out. I wouldn't.
You just said specifically you knew who the person was. Now, let me stop.
On the street, this is someone who I haven't talked to in years and fucking years, right? I was talking in generalized terms to make sure that I wasn't actually insulting anyone. I was trying to do it in as low of an inflammatory way as I possibly could.
Yeah, you didn't do a very good job at it. Now, I assume some of you have already heard all this, and I would assume somebody has said something to Gamer J Lee at this point. Someone let Gamer J Lee know that this guy's going to end up flagging him. I think that's very apparent right now. He's gonna wait for... Phil's going to wait until he can get enough on him, and then I would assume Gamer J Lee is getting flagged. I assume that's what that situation is going to be. Because Phil is kind of setting up the narrative in such a way to where he's the victim. And now this kid is harassing me. Because, you know, Gamer J Lee apparently is a kid, according to what Phil said. I said that too a couple times as well. But, you know, I was following what Phil said. Because Phil's always right. This kid's going to... Still doing it. Someone let Gamer J Lee know that he's got to be careful. Just be careful from here on out. Like I said, do what you feel is best for you, man. I'm not gonna tell you what to do, nor can anybody tell you what to do. But I'd say I'd be careful, because Phil is just resentful enough. He's just resentful enough to try to flag you or to get other people to flag you. And gay ops are afoot, apparently. I had asked a friend of mine about this recently. I was watching a Lightside Bill stream, I don't know which one it was. But he had mentioned that some dude at least was on Phil's stream saying his name. Now, granted, I don't know the full details of it or whatever, and I don't even know how the dude got it. But this goes back to something that I had heard a long ass time ago about there was gay ops against the tractors and whatnot. And so I'm not saying that Lightside Bill was on the end of that. I don't know. I haven't actually reached out to him on Twitter. Lightside Bill is a pretty busy guy, so I didn't want to bother him. But the way it sounded on his stream, somebody over there in Phil's camp at least knows Lightside Bill's name. That shouldn't be that big of a deal, but if you're sitting there trying to cheer using that name, that's a bit of an issue. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a bit of an issue, especially if he was pulling what sounded like the implication of gay ops to try to get it. So, just throwing that out there. So, someone should, I mean, you know, just some friendly advice to Gamer J. Lee. Someone pass it on to him. Just be careful. Just be careful. And the flag, when I say that, it doesn't mean that Phil flag you today. It don't mean he'll flag you next month. But eventually he's going to. He's going to. I would assume. He's going to at least try to. I don't think this is enough of a pretense to do so, but it's Phil Bruneau. So, he's sucking somebody's dick.
So the fact that this person took this story and literally turned it into their own story is so insane, over-the-top, ludicrous insanity. And that's probably the case in point of people who don't like me. That's probably why they don't like me, because they're that fucking nuts. That's all I can say about that.
All right. Yeah. That's, I don't know what to say about that. Thank you to Mighty D yet again and whatnot. Very much appreciate it. It's nice to have back-to-back videos. Give me a chance to clean up, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you guys in like a second. Yikes. Fun stuff. I don't know. Well, I would have liked it to be fun stuff. I thought it was going to be all laughs. I didn't think I was actually going to have any serious segments in this, to be honest. I thought it was just going to be kind of hilarious and pathetic, and it was really just kind of pathetic. All right, yet again, thank you very much to Mighty D. I very much appreciate it. Closing thoughts. I really just want to go back and start doing some old stuff, man. That's kind of what I want to do. I mean, don't be wrong. Like, I just... like, this shit is silly. This isn't a new low for Phil. But it's really pathetic. And it's really pathetic bait, to be honest. Like, it's a really sad state for him to try to stay face. Which, that's very obvious. Any of you guys can see that. It's him trying to multitask. He's trying to stay face. He's trying to go ahead and now... and try to protect his projection of some phantom fan out there who turned his back on him under the exact same circumstances as someone else who could prove their timeline. Him trying to get a big laugh over the detractor community, like, ha 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 ha, he wasn't the guy. You guys must feel stupid now. Like, he's trying to do too much in a very short amount of time. And if someone like myself can go ahead and dissect that, then I would assume everybody else already has. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is dumb. Like, this is really, really dumb. He was better off not saying anything and at least preserving some dignity. He doesn't gain any power by doing this. That's why he sat there and waited till the end of Minecraft and he's going to go on break the next day. Like, this is stupid. And if it was even remotely true, he would have addressed this last week. He wouldn't have sat on this for a week. Who would? You know what I'm saying? Like, who would? Unless you have some type of ulterior motive. But to do so, you got to craft a lie. And Phil is a liar, for sure, but he's not a good one. That's not a good lie. And it benefits nobody. Like, it just makes you look weak. You know what I'm saying? Like, it just makes you look weak. It makes you look inept. There's nothing here of substance. You know what I'm saying? And if I remember correctly, as a matter of fact, it might have been the light side build stream that I was telling you guys about. I think towards the end in Phil's chat, people were like, where's the proof? Where's the evidence? And he didn't have any. And he knew that. That's why he waited till the end of the stream to say that shit. So now the pignosis is barely working on the piglets that are supposed to, that is, it's intended for. So if you can't even get past them, then how are you going to get past the rest of us? This was just sad. This was really, really just kind of sad. It didn't have, there's no value to this. Sadly. I almost feel like I've wasted your time. I'm okay with still doing it, but I kind of felt like I wasted your time. Yikes. You have my apologies in advance, but I did buy drinks. And I made, you know, sweet and spicy BLT sandwiches. So hopefully that's some compensation for your time. I hope, you know, I hope, you know what I'm saying? Hopefully the Chio 18 commercial makes it all worth it. So hopefully that right there carries the day. But that's, you can't respect somebody like on this, for this, for any of this. He was better off just not saying anything. But Phil has to respond to every little thing. Every little thing he has to respond to, unless he's dead to rights wrong. And then he'll concede to it, but then he'll give you some roundabout fucking story to try to stay face. That's not a man, ladies and gentlemen. That's a coward. Period. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening, and I very much appreciate it. And I will see you guys for the next broadcast, whenever that may be. Hopefully with fun stuff. Hopefully. But we'll have to see. Thank you to all of you. Either which way, I very much appreciate it. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Ladies and gentlemen, this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking. Unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network of Productions. For the Snort Report, Snortbucks Coffee, Hard Snorts, and Tim Snortons, I've been your host / anchor, GTG, and I'm signing off. Take care of yourselves, guys. Take care of yourselves. End of broadcast. Yikes.